So for Triumph and Treachery, I've thought of team names and logos so people can cheer along their favorite player. First, I have Josh. For you, I've come up with Josh's Juggernauts.
I like it. It'll work.
Doug, this one's for you. Here we go. Doug's Dragons. Fiery, red, kind of like the corn dragon.
So how come there's not like two or more dragons and they don't look very tough?
It's a dragon. It's implied. Next. Brent's Berserkers.
Is that Sub-Zero?
Actually, we couldn't afford Sub-Zero. This is his non-union equivalent. And next, we have Jack's Draconic Berserking Juggernauts. And...
Oh, that kind of just seems like a combination of like all three of ours.
Well, when you make teams and you spend money and you go to the print store...
What's up, Liches? Who wants to roll dice and lose?
Ah, shoot. Perfect timing. The last team name is... Shoes, Shoes.
Shoes, Shoes.
Why can't it be Brent's Shoes?
Hello, Internet. This is Shu, and this is my Magic Ken of Nurgle army. 480 points of Magic Ken of Nurgle, to be precise, which I love doing. Up here, we have a Harbinger of Decay. His artifact is a Witherstab, and his command trait from the Nurgle Mortal Tree, just to make sure I'm doing it right, he has the Living Plague command trait. Over here, we have a unit of Light Kings. Over here, another unit of Light Kings. We have the Cycle of Corruption up there, and then some... Narumaz, which may or may not make a presence this battle. That is 480 points of Magic Kid of Nurgle. Triumph and Treachery, let's go.
It's Jack, and today I'm playing Iron Jaws, because destruction needs some love. We're playing Triumph and Treachery, we're taking roughly 500 points, and so I'm going to have this, what's his name?
Mega Boss
on foot. He's going to be my general, and I'm going to roll for my command traits and magic items. So my command trait, I rolled a 4. That is... Bestial Charisma. If the general is chosen as the model from which the Inspiring Presence command ability is measured, you can pick D3 units rather than one. That's not going to do me any good, but I rolled for it. And my item, 6, that is the Boss Skewer. Add 1 to the bravery characteristics of friendly Iron Jaws units while they are wholly within 18 of the bearer, and subtract 1 from the bravery of characteristics of enemy units while they are wholly within 18 of the bearer. That's pretty cool. And, yeah.
You can re-roll that command trait if you want. That was...
I will. Because that is...
We want to make this fun, yeah. And not doing a thing isn't fun. Yeah.
4. That's the same thing. Yes, yeah. It is.
Do you roll one more time?
1. Hulking muscle-bound brute. You can re-roll wound rolls of 1 for attacks made with the general's melee weapons. I'll take that. From my army, I have a unit of brutes with the boss claw and the brute smasher. And the big,
Gore Chopper,
yes. That is, and I have the Shaman. And that's about 440 points, I believe, so I will get a command point. So that's my army. Good luck, Jack.
Doug here with some Caradhran Overlords for rerolling ones for the first time. And what we have here is 5 Grunstock Thunderers, and they are all armed with the Aethershot Rifles, just to make the simple profile. Just Chemist in the front there. As my general, a unit of 10 Arcanaut Company with the full array of weapons, like the big Gatling Gun guy, Skyhook, and that kind of stuff. And in the back here, we have a unit of 3 Engine Riggers, all armed with rapid-fire rivet guns and Ethermatic Saw, just the base loadouts for all of them. And I'm going to run them as Barrack Mornar, which restricts kind of the Caradhran Code stuff that I have. Realistically, what it does is I get to reroll Battleshock tests when I'm in my enemy's territory, which will be most of the board, seeing as how there's a bunch of guys. My friend's really terrible and trying to hinder me from doing this correctly. And cool stuff is I can shoot and run in the first turn. And I can also, in the shooting phase, pick 1 unit, and everyone gets to reroll hit rolls against that unit. My artifact I'm going to bring on the Chemist is the Staff of Ocular Optimization, which is +1 to any hit rolls he makes in the shooting phase.
His eyeballs are optimized.
Hey everyone, this is Brent with a 490-point Night Haunt army. It's got some of Shu's spirit hosts, so they're a nice mint color. And the rest of mine are going to be a blue raspberry. Anyway, the leader of my army is going to be my Lord Executioner. He's going to have the command trait Ruler of the Spirit Hosts. I have a Spirit Torment who's going to have the magical artifact, the Pendant of the Fell Winds. I have a unit of 5 Dreadscythe Harridans. I have a unit of 10 Chain Rasp Horde. And I have a unit of 3 Spirit Hosts. So that's going to be 490 points of Night Haunt. We're going to be playing Rite of Conquest, a Triumph and Treachery scenario. You're scoring victory points by either scoring your secret objective, which we're going to show to you individually, so you at home know what we're trying to achieve, and none of us will know what the other players are looking to do. You're scoring 1 victory point for in each phase for every 5 wounds you inflicted in that phase, and you're scoring D3 victory points for each territory in which one of your models is closer to the center of the territory than any other models belonging to the other players. And if there's a tie, it's just going to score each of those players 1 victory point. You can see there's 6 territories we're going to be setting up in, and also the length of the game is not determined. That is determined at the end of the 4th battle round. We're going to be rolling a dice, and if we roll higher than the total number of players that we have, the game is going to end. Excuse me, if we roll higher than the total number of players we have, the game is going to continue. If not, it's going to end.
This is Josh. I'm bringing the Seraphon. I got my Slan with Drotoka with Incandescent Rectrices. I got my Warden, who's yet to earn a name, and a unit of guard. And that is 490 points. His command trait will be Great Rememberer.
We're going to roll to see who gets to deploy first.
You don't know, but I didn't win.
It's a 6. Oh, I'm a 6 as well.
Who's the 6 roll off? All right. 4 and... Nope. Do it again.
Do that about 4 more times.
Oh, you finally beat me.
All right, I will deploy first. So I won the roll off, and I get to choose the order in which we deploy. First, I will choose my brother Josh. He's going to deploy first. Then Shu. And then we're going with 2 plus Tough Doug, Brent, and I will deploy last. And again, I want to let people know, only reason I'm wearing these sunglasses indoors is because these lights give me bad headaches.
So you're not a douchebag?
I'm not a douchebag because the glasses. I'm a douchebag because the other stuff in my life. Like
So we're rolling for secret objectives. This is Brent. I'm rolling for Night Haunt, and I'm not saying out loud what we get, so you all see that.
Because we're all in the room.
Everyone's in the room. This is my secret objective.
Hello, Internet. This is Shu, and I'm rolling for the secret objective for Nurgle for this army, or for this match. Let's see what happens. That's the number I got. And so you can pause the video and read this one, and try to ignore my chubby fingers.
This is Doug with the Kerrigan Overlords, rolling for my secret objective. Yeah, I'll put this here so it's easy to see.
It's Jack with Iron Jaws, and I am rolling for my secret objective.
This is Josh, and rolling for my secret objective.
So we are playing in Shaman, the Realm of Metal, because Doug's a jerk. And I'm going to roll for the RealmScape feature. 2. Worse than the ring character... there's no Citadel, Wildwoods, or... So it doesn't do anything. Just reroll that. Reroll that. 4. Okay,
no, that's
the one
that's
that
even
actually
more boring.
Doesn't do
anything.
Let's get something. 4. Here we go. Steel Rain. At the start of your hill phase, roll a dice. On a 6+, pick an enemy unit that is not in cover. Roll a die for each model in that unit, inflicting 1 mortal wound for each roll that is less than the unit's save characteristics. A save characteristics of dash counts as a 6 for the purpose of this rule.
Sounds cool to me.
Steel Rain.
Taking a look at the battlefield here, we've got some inspiring terrain. Look how inspired the entire Iron Jaws army is up on that hill. We've got some sinister terrain, which is so sinister, nobody is hanging out next to that. Here is the Magikin of Nurgle army next to some damned terrain.
It's fitting. And there's the normal Maw in the center of the table. Over here, all the Seraphon are set up on the Sinister Terrain, but they're all Bravery 10, so they don't really care. They are well defended, getting a cover save. Over here, the Night Haunt next to some mystical terrain and some inspiring terrain, because Night Haunt definitely need more bravery. And then over here are the Karadrin Overlords next to some mystical terrain and some damned terrain. Maybe Barak Mornar is unscrupulous enough to sacrifice their own guys for plus one to hit. I'm not sure. Looking at the whole board here now, it's going to go to Shu to roll for the
Cycle of Contagion.
Yeah.
Here we go. It's going to be a two, which is going to be, a survey says, Fecund Vigor. Add one to the wound rolls of all attacks made by Nurgle units in the combat phase.
Alright, now I'm rolling to see what constellation is ascended. Four, so that's plus one to casting. It's called the Sage Staff.
Ready?
So in Triumph and Treachery, all players roll at the start of every battle round. Whoever wins the roll off gets to decide who gets to take the first turn, and then after they complete their turn, all of the remaining players will roll off again. So there's lots of priority rolls every turn in Triumph and Treachery. So here we go, rolling for turn one. Not me.
I got a six.
Who got the six? So, Doug, you get to decide who takes the first turn in battle round one.
Okay. I don't know. Let me think about that.
Starting off the hero phase of Karadrin Overlords, I like to go first. First thing I have to do is choose. I'm going to ignore all that. Choose which opponent I'm going to fight this round. I'm going to say these Iron Jaws over here because Jack's making all kinds of noise.
What?
So the first thing I do is roll for the Realmscape feature right here on a six. Nope, nothing happens. That's cool. Beyond that, my Chemist right down here is going to do his super buff and picks a weapon profile of a nearby unit and gets plus one attacks to that weapon profile. So he's going to do that to the engine riggers right behind him. Jump in the movement phase. One thing that's important to know with Barak Mornar, I can run and shoot the first turn of the game. So this Arcanaut company here is going to run, and they're going to go a powerful 6 inches.
As fitting of Dwarden.
And the same thing's going to happen with the engine riggers back here. They have a 12-inch move base. Extra five. Here.
It's the stuff you guys don't know that's happening off camera. That's really entertaining.
They're trying to get me. Thunderers are going to run as well. And lastly, the Chemist. Starting off the shooting phase, all the engine riggers are going to fire their shots into the mega boss back here. They're well within 24 inches.
Yeah, and to clarify, so you're picking that all of your shots can only go to the Iron Jaws. Jack is the enemy.
We got to make a championship belt at the end of this, you guys.
Can I have three more dice?
Out of cardboard? I can do that.
Three more dice? Here we go. Yeah, this is a bit of the beginning of a rivalry, you know.
Yeah,
Hulk
so
Hogan versus
to start off here, the Chemist is going to choose this guy here as the target for the round. Part of Barak Mornar, I pick one guy, I say, heck to heck with that guy, and then everyone in 3 inches of the general gets to reroll hit rolls against him. So these guys are not a part of that, but I have to declare it. Starting off here with these guys winning the Mega Boss, they get plus one to their shooting attack because of the Chemist's.
I do have lookout, sir, so they're minus one as well.
Okay, so that is, what is it, four ups now? Hitting on fours, unless there's, I'll double check, make sure I'm not missing any rules on that.
What does lookout, sir, sound like in Orc?
And he should be forced to wound.
There's three.
Four.
Okay, what's the rend?
Rend of one.
Alright, he has three up save, going to two, back up to three because I'm recovered. So, I took one. How many damages?
One damage.
One damage, alright.
Jumping into the Thunder unit here. All going to fire at that Shaman up on the hill. So, because of the way cover works, I get to reroll failed hits except for threes. That's the way the modifier thing works.
grab these, pull these out.
Yeah, modifiers after rerolls.
Boom. So just I got one more out of that.
Cool.
All right, and these are all going to be forced to wound. All right, just one save at a minus one.
All right, so he has a 5-up save. Please cover goes to 4, but back up to 5 with the minus one. Saved it.
The Arcanaut Company, only the first few guys and the special weapons can all see the shaman up there. So I'll start with the Skyhook. It is one shot, hitting on a 4, but he rerolls because he's still targeting that guy. And that will hit you. And then 3 to wound. Yep. That does it.
What's the rend on that?
That is going to be rend 2.
Okay, so it goes straight through.
Well, you got cover, so you got a 6 up.
Oh,
yeah, but keep that, keep that.
You can get a 6, you're fine.
Okay, nope. You're taking 3 damage.
Okay.
3 damage, okay. And then next to that is the volley gun, which has an 18-inch range right there. And these are all hitting on 5s.
They're actually hitting on 4s. They're getting plus 1 to hit Arcanauts against heroes or monsters.
That is
plus
true. And then hit. Minus 1 because of...
All right, sir. So I'm...
So what is that?
Nonsense.
Well, these all hit. These will reroll because he's still the target of choice.
Nice.
Yeah, you're good.
Followed up, man.
5 plus hits.
1, minus 1. Yeah, negative 2. Mm-hmm. And you're going to be wounding on 4s.
Just 1.
Just one goes through at a minus 1.
5 up. Nope. He has 2 wounds left.
1 damage, yep. He has 2 wounds left total.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, and the 4 guys up here, the leader guy gets an extra shot with his pistol. And they're going to be hitting on these 5s now. Oh, no, it's plus 1 because it's a hero guy, right?
Yeah, yeah.
So, yeah. It doesn't really matter.
Back to force.
Yep. Anyway, these are rerolls. That's right. That's why I'm doing this. 3. And then force to wound.
Oh, you kill me.
Uh-oh.
Yeah. No random.
Right on that.
The machine gun.
We're up. Oh, I died. Oh, no.
Come down. First so blood. He's, how many wounds was he? 6?
6 wounds.
And then you did 1 on the megaboss. So, Doug, in the shooting phase, you are scoring 1 victory point for causing at least 5 wounds. So that's going to conclude the Kerridgen Overlord's turn 1. Took out the Weird Knob Shaman. So now the rest of us need to dice off and see who gets to go next.
Triple fives. All that.
Everybody but you.
Get guys.
Out. Yeah, you're out of here.
Yeah, you're blocking.
6.
And you get to pick.
Let me go ahead and think about this.
Right. Brent got the dice off, and he selected Iron Jaws.
Yeah, I had to bribe him. I wanted to get some revenge. I'm itching for it. So, in my hero phase, guess who's going to be my enemy? Doug. So, I need a 6 to Vromsky feature. Doesn't go off. Now I'm going to go for my movement. So, I will select myself to go on a 4+, because I'm a mega boss. Nope, doesn't happen. And I think that's it for my hero phase. I don't think Iron Jaws have anything else to do. Now I'm going to go to my movement phase. Movement phase, enemy again, is the Kerridgen Overlords, and I'm going to move him up to here. These guys will just shuffle down. Hopefully I can get a long charge. That's about an inch down, so we'll just go 3. Oh. Don't have any shooting, but if I did, Doug would still be my enemy. So we're going to charge phase. Hey, guess what? I'm picking Doug. So first thing first, I'm going to charge my mega boss.
Twos.
On foot. 5. I think that's going to make it.
We're at 6. He's getting plus 1.
Oh, yeah, that's right. Yes, he's in there.
Big daddy.
Got to go with the brutes next. Let's get a big one. 7. They're going to get in. I have 2 command points. I'm going to spend 1 to reroll that.
Alright.
Nope, that's worse.
Whoa.
I failed it, so I can't even do mass smashing and bashing. See, it's a gamble.
It is a gamble.
It's a gamble. Alright. Combat phase. I'm selecting my big boss, gonna pile in. And I'm gonna attack you with my Riptooth Fist, hitting on 5s. Oh, 1 hit, wounding on 3s. 1 wound at a negative 2.
Alright, so it's 6 up. No.
And that is D3 wounds. 3. This is mystical terrain if you select that guy.
Oh, yeah. So, 3?
Mm-hmm.
2. It's 6s, right? Yeah. 7.
So, no. 3 wounds.
That is a dude and a half.
If it's 1s, it would have been much better.
Yeah.
They're like 6s.
I guess I want to keep the guy next to the terrain, right?
Yes.
Okay.
No. You would have to take him out because he died. But I think he's within reach too, so you'll be fine.
But I mean, like, that's where I got. Never mind.
Yeah.
Good.
And going with my boss Choppa, I hit on threes, wound on threes. All right, that's five hits, wounding on threes, and because of my command ability, I'm rerolling ones to wound. There's a one there. Nope, didn't matter. Three at negative one.
Oh man, I'm gonna roll these black dice as well. Let's see. Negative one, so I have five ups.
Ooh, look at them all!
Black dice are broken!
Always been on black, baby.
Oh,
tagging him right back, the Blimpy boys are going to strike. We have three attacks, so they're one each, and the hero gets an additional attack here. These are the Ethermatic Saws, looking for threes to hit.
Nice.
And going to be twos, sorry, yeah, twos to wound, of course.
Well.
And, yeah, take one save at a minus two.
All right, so I have a three-up save, going to five. Oh!
And it's D3 damage.
Oh, three!
Oh, my gosh!
Huge! Ow! Okay. So I took one earlier, so I have three wounds left.
As far as battle shot goes, they only have one guy. And just as a side note, Beric Mornar, if I'm in the enemy's territory, I get to re-roll it. So that's something to remember for the rest of the game. But these guys don't have to roll right now.
They're safe for battle shock.
Yep.
Nerf KO.
Roll off. Final three. Four, three, three. You got a three.
You go. What are you going to do?
I'm going to Josh go next.
All right, so since we're going next, what we're going to do is we're going to bank that command point, and we are going to...
Also, who's your enemy for the hero phase?
My enemy for the hero phase will be Night Hunt.
Cool. So you can roll a dice and see if that that metal rain is going to rain down on me.
Oh!
Six. Okay, so I'm going to pick that unit there.
This is brutal. This is him rolling less than my save inflicts a mortal wound. They have a five-up save, so that's going to be five mortal wounds. I have Deathless Spirits here. Here's my general, right? I'm wholly within 12 inches. On sixes, I can ignore these. I ignore two. So three Chain Transport are going to get killed by rain.
Excellent.
Now I'm going to conjure three times, and I have a slam, so that puts me at 10 summoning points. I'm going to back up.
This is how everything ended up. Now we're going on to shooting. Do you have any shooting?
No shooting.
All right, and no what? Charges? Or do you want to... I don't think that's 12 inches, actually.
At the end of my movement phase, I'm spending six of my conjuring points. That leaves me with four, and I'm bringing in a salamander.
Excellent. And that is the end of Seraphon, because there's no shooting and no charges. So now we need a roll off. Oh, no, it's just Brent's turn.
No.
Oh.
Mark and roll again.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Actually, yeah, Mark and Brent. Let's get this dice.
Whoa, I get a six.
A two of four.
Your choice.
I'll go next.
Okay, Josh is very nice because like he's in front of me. He's like, okay, you're gonna be my enemy, but wait, if you're in cover, you cannot be affected by the metal rain. They take cover. So for the hero phase, I'm actually going to select Mark to be the enemy, and let's see if he gets dumped on. Nope, Seattle rain. Okay, so now I'll be able to continue the rest of my hero phase. First, ruler of the spirit host, I'll be able to heal D3 models into this unit. So I'm going to get two of these models back. So two Chain Rasphorid models have returned. Now I have the Pendant of the Fell Wind. So all Night Haunt that start their movement phase within 12 inches of the Spirit Torment are going to get plus three to their movement. So there's nothing else to do in the hero phase. So then the movement phase, I'm selecting Josh as the enemy. Okay, so the Night Haunt movement phase, Josh is going to be the enemy. There's nothing I can do to him in the movement phase, but it just, what does it mean? It means something, right? So I'm getting plus three to my movement for all of my units from Pendant of the Fell Winds. So these Dread Scythe Herodons, you know, they're actually going to run. I think they're not even going to try and do a charge right now. So they're going to add six to their movement. They're going to go ahead and go 14,
The gentleman's 14. The
gentleman's 14. The chain rasp horde are going to move their 9.
And I just noticed that this is mystical terrain. Do you want to roll for that last chain rasp, just in case?
Oh, that's a good point.
Oh, he's back.
Okay, well, I'm going to go add him back to the unit later. It's a thanks for pointing that out. Here you go, the spirit hosts.
Minty fresh.
Minty fresh. And I'll keep the heroes right up behind them.
All right, that's movement.
I'm going to charge with... So I'm declaring Josh as the enemy. I am charging with the spirit hosts. It's kind of the only charge that... Okay! I'll take the 12, and I'm also getting Wave of Terror. So let me go ahead and move that, and I will fight a round of combat.
Don't count your chickens before they hatch.
No more charges?
I have to fight Wave of Terror first.
Oh, yeah, that's right. Yeah.
Okay, so for Wave of Terror, that is if I roll an unmodified 10 or more when Nighthaunt charge, they get to fight a round of combat in the charge phase, and then that doesn't prevent them from attacking later in the combat phase. So my free wave of spooky ghost attacking, I don't know. All three spirit hosts are going to attack the temple guard. They are hitting on 5s, but doing mortal wounds on 6s. So there's at least one mortal wound. And then let me check here. I am not getting Nagash's billing. I don't get to reroll that. So I've done one mortal wound, and then I can wound on a 4. Okay, so that's it. Just one mortal wound. I'm going to charge with the chain rasp horde as well, actually, since the spirit host actually made it in. An 8. Do I want them to join in the fight? They can fly. Yeah, and I might be able to throw some attacks on the salamander. So this guy, he's just going to go right here. The rest of them. Okay, so the charge phase is complete, so we're going to go into combat. I, again, am selecting Josh as the enemy, and I'm going to select the spirit host to attack first. And this guy, let's see if I can pile in a little bit. Is that enough to... No, it's not, but whatever. Okay, well, I'm going to attack with the spirit host now. So again, 6s are mortal wounds from Frightful Touch. So there's 2 mortal wounds, 1 other hit on a 5, wounding on a 4, doesn't go through. So 2 more mortal wounds.
Alright, so I'm going to select the Temple Guard. Alright, so I'm selecting the Temple Guard. Now, they have an extra attack with their pole arm because the warden's within 5 inches. But I'm going to do their bite attack first. Hits on 5s, and they're attacking the ghost. Or the spirit host. Hits on 5s. Nope. Okay, so now, rolling for the weapon. So it's going to be against the spirit host as well. Hits on 3s. And 3 is the wound.
It's 4 wounds.
4 wounds.
I'm taking these 4. And
minus 1.
All right,
that you don't care about.
Yeah, ethereal, so I'm keeping my 4 up save.
Took 3 damage.
3, so goodbye, Spirit Host.
Oops. Oh! Poof. Back to hell or whatever place you go.
So this is definitely a weird pile-in, since I'm, you know... Yeah, wobbly model, I guess I'm floating up here, doing my best. Okay, there's 2 guys up there. There are definitely 2 chain rasp up here fighting the salamander. They're going to attack. They need 4s to hit with their malignant weapons. They are not rerolling 1s because they're not wholly within 12 inches of the spirit torment. And they're wounding on 4s, but they fail. So then the other 5, including... No, not the Dread Warden. So Let's see, I'm just going to grab all these. Here we go. 10 attacks on the Temple Guard. These are hitting on fours. And they're rerolling wound rolls of one since for Chilling Horde, since I have all 10 of my models back. That's good, because that was real bad. Okay, there. So there's two wounds on the Temple Guard, but there's no rend.
What is the save on the Temple Guard?
Okay, well, the save is plus their save is a four, but while they're within 8 inches of a hero, they get plus one and plus two of their bravery, and they're in cover. So that'll be plus two, so it'll be twos.
Mm-hmm. Yep, save them both.
Salamander has three attacks. It's going to be threes to hit. And threes to one.
No misses. And that is it for the combat phase. Now to Battle Shock. Are currently bravery 12, so they can't fail. The ghosts are bravery 10, they can't fail. And now.
Minus one, yeah. Still can't fail.
Still can't fail. Mm-hmm. Now it's over to. What are you guys looking at? That's it. It's you, yeah. That was very guilty.
Okay. For the Nurgle Rapbringer hero phase, I'm going to try to jump rain again onto Jack. Sorry, Jack.
No,
not gonna happen anyways. All right. No big deal. It's all right.
That wasn't take two or anything.
Forgive it. So my contagion points, I have three for this territory, one for no enemy models within my borders, and I'm gonna roll D3 for this Narmah here. Four. That's gonna be two. Not enough to summon another tree this round. So we're gonna go right into my hero phase. My Harbinger of Decay is going to use the command ability Morbid Vigor, which is going to give everybody around him within 7 inches a 5-up additional save against wounds and mortal wounds. It's a little bit like, what is the demon version of that, which is a disgusting resilience. Yeah. Thank you. Mr. Lore Guy, how would you have known this? Okay.
Sorry, I can't look at this sad stuff over here.
It's okay. Well, I'm going to have to go right into my movement phase next. Going to go directly into the movement phase. We're going to run this unit of Putrid Blight Kings. You're going to go an extra 2 inches. So that isn't going to be a lot.
You get plus one, too, from the Sonar's Toxin.
Well, that's a good point. So that brings them up to 8, right? 8 inches?
7.
7 inches. Yeah, right. Oh, they're 4.
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah, they're not in great shape.
Running the Harbinger of Decay. Ooh. I don't even know what to do with all this.
Former racehorse.
Yes, yes.
That's what they do with them after, you know, they've completed like 3 times.
Put them right about here.
It's sad.
I mean, I'm just looking for a Nurgle pun for Secretariat, and it wasn't coming, so.
Okay, these guys are going 5 inches.
6 inches.
Right, because of the sonorous toxin.
Are there any puns for Seabiscuit? No, I can't think of any. It was a fast horse, and he...
There's a movie about it, right?
Yeah. End of Shu's turn. Running. Can't run in charge, so that's his turn. And we're going to move on to not Robot Dice Roll Off, because there's too many of us, but.
Multi Dice Roll Off.
All right, we're rolling off. I really need this. I want everybody to remember how nice I am. And we're at my house. I'm a host. Yeah. I offer you guys water.
You gave us pizza once.
Yeah.
There's Sunny D in the fridge.
There's alcohol, but nobody here drinks. and just remember, every time you guys give Doug a model, he sells it 3 months later. So
You at least have never sold one of the donations. Here we go. Five for Nurgle. It's going to be Nurgle.
Nurgle. Okay. You know what you're doing? No, you're going double turn. Okay.
Yeah, this is why it's double turn.
The cycle of contagion moves to the burgeoning. Roll a dice at the end. I'm sorry. Roll a dice for each unit within 1 inch. I'm an old man, so I had to like take my bifocals off.
Every unit in the game. Hold on.
Roll a dice for each unit within 1 inch of terrain feature at the start of your hero phase. On a roll of 5 or more, that unit suffers a mortal wound. Nurgle units heal a wound instead. Oh. I've got no wounds to heal, so let's just start going.
All right, pick a point out a guy. It's right. These ghosts.
So these ghosts here. Oh, they're going to take a wound.
Mortal wound.
You want to heal a mortal wound there on your... okay, can't. Yeah, these guys here. A 2.
They're good. What about the slan?
The slan. Oh, he's getting one. This guy,
Cardor
with his spear staff, spirit staff, whatever it is. Those guys are safe. This guy here.
Mm-hmm.
Nope.
Okay. You got these chain rasp hordes here?
Chain rasps.
Okay.
They get one.
Salamander?
Sally the Mander. No.
Right. Oh, I get Death of Spirits over here at least.
You have
Arcanauts next. That's not a thing. Sorry, everybody. Sorry. No, they're going to take a wound.
Get the guy with the spike, the pike. Take him off.
The guy in the back. The guys in the back.
Thunderers, yep.
Thunderers, no. Those guys.
Blimby boys.
No.
Good.
Brutes.
Brutes. Yes.
No!
Just love the battlefield just cried out.
Oh, yeah. That's mystical terrain.
Take the,
oh, yeah.
Dude.
Here we go.
Oh, yeah. What's the range on the...
Oh, yeah.
He's fine.
Never mind. You didn't die.
Thanks, Mark.
So this is mystical. Oh, so wait, is it 3 inches?
I'm rolling for the contingent points to D3 here. It's going to bring me to 7, which means I can put a tree on the table at the end of my movement phase.
Mm.
Okay, this is going to be the hero phase for Magikin and Nurgle. This tree is here for reference. I will put it here at the end of my movement phase, but I just want to move models around it so I know it's outside of the territory of other stuff. It's just to make things easy because I have a tiny brain.
Comment below if you think that's cheating. No.
Yeah, comment below. Yeah. Comment below with a poem about the phase I'm about to have. Pause the video and comment below. If your poem is super awesome, I will pin it.
Haiku.
Haiku, yes. The Magikin... okay, the Harbinger of Decay is going to use his command ability, which is going to give everybody the bonus to their saving throw, and then we're going to go right into movement. Okay, I have set up a line here for myself. I'm going to run this Harbinger of Decay. He's fine. He's just going to go right up to the line. These guys here, 4 plus 1, it's going to go 5 inches.
Remember, you get plus 2.
Right.
Ding dong.
Because of the bell. He's cranking right up there in front, too.
Oh. Cowbell solo. I'm
glad you don't have the one painted like my Stormcast. Oh, no, he's probably over there somewhere, you jerk.
He's probably in there. Okay, D6 for these guys, running them as well. Oh, I don't know if they're going to make it. They'll make it.
What happened?
Okay, end of the movement phase. Yeah.
End of the movement phase. The tree goes down.
Boop.
Boop. I want to make sure that it's outside of 9 from this guy here. He has to be like this. And then wholly within 7 for the hero. And
wait, 12 seven. For the hero.
Thank you. Yeah. Yes. We're going to select Josh as the enemy. He's closer. So here we go. Charging the Harbinger of Decay. He's going to go meet that slan on the hill of battle. Whoop. Now going with these guys. So to be clear, this tribe in treachery, I cannot attack Brent because he's not my enemy.
Well, you could if you choose that in the combat phase. You can choose a different enemy.
Right, but then I couldn't attack Josh if that was the case.
Right.
So I'm going to charge myself an inch to get up there. This is at 8 inches here. I don't think I'm going to make it.
We have a 9-inch charge because of the toxins.
Oh, right, right. Well, that will just put me in range of one guy. We'll do this. Cool. Well, this is a once-per-battle ability I don't use very often. The Rot Sword. Once per battle at the start of your hero... okay, I'll have to do that in hero phase. If I survive... we're going to go with the Plague Scythe. 3 attacks going into the slan. Hitting on 3s, winning on 3s. That's 2. And winning on 3s. That's 2. And it's run 1.
4 up. Okay, so a 4 up to 3 up to a 4 up.
Ooh.
Now.
Can you reroll?
I'm going to roll. Okay, the Warden has Selfless Protector, which means each time this model is within 2 inches of a slan that suffers a wound or mortal wound, it can attempt to intervene. If it does so, roll a dice. If the result is 2 or higher, the slan ignores the wound or mortal wound, but the model suffers a mortal wound in its place.
All right, let's see how many wounds or mortal wounds you do.
It's going to be a total of 4 wounds.
4 wounds. So you have to roll a dice for each. Takes them off,
okay.
Right?
So.
Takes 4 mortal wounds.
4 mortal wounds.
Is this the bee attack?
This is the bee attack.
Bees
okay, the horse has bees in his mouth. He's going to roll D6 attacks with that. He's going to get 3 dice.
There's nothing more powerful than bees.
Nothing more powerful. They hit on 4s. And they wound on fours. Oh, that's two, no Ren.
No Ren, so you got your three up save.
Alright, four up save, three up because I'm in cover.
Bing, bing.
Bing, bang.
Super bulletproof from bees.
Bee repellent.
Bees are lunch for a frog.
Absolutely.
Alright, so I'm going to activate the Source Guard. And now, since Brent is no longer my enemy and Shu is, I get to pile in towards the closest enemy model.
I'm going to pull you out of combat with those ghosts.
I'm going to go right over here.
My army just looks disappointed.
Fine. I don't want to fight you anyway.
Now we're going to do their bite attack, which is a 5.
Chomp, chomp.
Yep, got 1. 4. All right, there we go. No rend.
Okay, so we have a 4 up. Got it.
Okay. And now they get +1 attack with their pole arms, and the leader gets an extra attack, so now we need 3s.
Nice.
And 3s.
Pole armed.
So 3 attacks.
It's pole arming.
And -1.
-1. So we're looking for 5s. And how much damage is that?
1 damage each.
And the 5s again for the Disgusting Resilience effect. Not really Disgusting Resilience, but similar.
More so you're, bigger.
Yes. So you're going to do wounds. 2 wounds. Cool. Well, we were going to pile the as far as we can. We'll make a little bit of room for his buddy. Get a buddy up there.
Oop. Wherever he goes, you're going to go.
That's right. And we'll just pile this way, just in case Brent wants to play later. I want to make it easy for you.
You want to play?
No.
You want
to
play?
I came to play!
Alright, these are hitting on 3s, wounding on 3s. 6s are going to explode and be special.
Don't do it.
That goes way. We got 1 6 in there. That 6 is going to become 3 dice. And then these are the wound rolls here. Wounding on 3s. That is 5.
5. And any rend on that?
No rend.
All right, Josh, you have 5 with your 2 up save. Anyone?
Don't care.
Nope, oh, he does not care.
Down.
Take that.
Make this one too. One more. Doesn't even matter.
Oh, there it is. Take your wound.
That's why I stopped at the other one.
Yeah.
Ready?
Quiet on set. Slan is attacking the Harbinger of Decay.
Harbinger.
Okay, 6 attacks. 4 is the hit.
Ooh, 2 hits.
I guess.
And 3 is the wound.
2 wounds?
Oh, I guess 3. You're letting me down. Okay, here we go. Yeah, I think that makes them both. I believe he's hit 3.
Okay.
Charged. No, yeah.
Oh,
so you do a point of damage?
Yes. How many damage is it? Just 1?
It's just 1.
Okay.
And then you get Morbid Vigor.
Right. Morbid Vigor. On a 5. He ignores it. Nope.
1 damage. Josh just needs to score 2 more and he gets a point.
Alright, now I'm attacking back with the Warden with his jaws. 4 is the hit.
You roll it.
I'll re-roll it.
Hit.
Uh-oh.
And 4 is the wound.
Nope. Yeah.
Okay, now he has 3 attacks with his mace. 3 is the hit. And 3 is the wound. So 1 goes through at -1 rent.
5 up. Makes it.
Got it. Got a pile in for the salamander over here. And now Josh is going to attack
just
with his
3
attacks. Hit on 3s, wound on 3s. 1 hit.
Rerolling that one.
So you need 2 more wounds to do this?
Nope.
No!
And
okay, he did wound.
So 4 up, armor save. -1 up, 5s. And then 5s.
Morbid Vigor.
No! Okay. All these dice in the trees. Hold on. Okay, I'm gonna make it. So save them, sorry. And go.
So now that we got the wild card Shu out of the way.
2.
2.
You got a 5?
Yeah.
Oh,
man. I'm gonna go ahead and pick me.
Okay.
Alright, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna conjure 3 times. So that get and +1 for having a slant, so that gives me 10 plus my 4, so I'm at 14. And I'm gonna Lords of Space and Time. I'm gonna attempt to do it twice. So Here's for my slam. With a 4, so he's good. And then 1 for my
Star-Lord,
my warden. And he's good. He's gonna make it.
They're out of here. Right. Josh, you just lords of space and time? Is that what happened? Where did they go? They were here, but now they're not there. They're not there.
Like Blue's Clues?
Well, they're there!
There!
Way over there! There's like nothing over there. What's going on?
This is definitely the first Age of Sigmar channel to reference Blue's Clues.
I'm going to pick Shu as my enemy for the
well
hero
done
phase.
Yes, he should.
So,
dump rain.
Right here, we're going to do 5.
We got to roll a 6 first.
Yeah, I
got
to roll
1 dip.
Oh, yeah, that's right. Yeah, here goes the 6. Okay.
Oh.
Yeah. Dang.
Do you have to roll for all my units?
No.
Okay, just the one you care about. Oh, you care about me.
At the end of my movement phase, Khygar comes into the battle.
Khygar. Kardor.
He's a Sunblood.
Look at that shield. That shield. All right. Shooting phase.
Yeah, in my shooting phase, since I'm in combat, I have to pick Shu as my enemy. Well, I don't have to pick him, because if I don't pick him, somebody else will be. But I'm going to pick Shu. Alright, so, and I'm gonna shoot. It's a 3's to hit. And
3. Acid spit.
Yep, and 3's to win. There we go.
Got it.
-2 rank.
-2. Okay, so that puts me at 6 for the Black Kings.
Oh,
and they don't.
That was
D6
damage.
Yeah.
They don't care.
That was a good
Nobody
one.
Cares.
Alright, combat phase. We're gonna pick shoot. And, let's go ahead and attack with this salamander.
Nice.
We got 2 hits. 3's the one. 1 wound.
Oh, there's a 1 there. Oh, no. Ooh. Okay, so we got a 5 into the 5. 5 up. Oh, cranked it with 6.
All right, so now...
She's turn to attack back.
It's your turn.
Combat phase. The sonorous toxin carrier is going to go into the... salamander. 6's explode. That's an exploding 6. It turns into 1 extra hit. Awesome. Good job. Winning on 3's. And so that's 2 hits, no rend onto the salamander.
There you go.
You go ahead.
Salamander, save. Here we go.
Salamander has a 5 save.
He's in cover, so he's up to 4.
Oh.
So make one, take one.
That's the curse of Shu. He's just
You're gonna have to knock stuff down every time. That's why I build this stuff.
And then you've got one more Blight King or 2 more Blight Kings,
right.
On this Jack, what is this guy doing? What's his
stand alone?
Okay, gonna hit him 6 dice. Here we go. 6's are special, but none of those. Lots of 1's. So 3 hits. 3 wounds onto your guy who's standing alone.
Okay, now he's got a 4-up save, which goes to a 3-up, and that's it.
Which is...
Nice!
Oh, no.
He doesn't care.
4, 5, 6. Yeah, there we go.
This guy's awesome.
Fight. 5's hit. Nope. Okay, for his weapon, 3's the hit. Nope.
Oh, no.
They're just watching this happen.
Oh. All right, thanks to Josh's benevolence, I'm going to pile in my hero. I thought this guy was up here on the rock, but he had piled down lower during his turn.
That looks way better, because it's really funny, like him just on the horse vertical up on the hill like this.
I'm Skyrim!
Yeah, exactly.
All right, here we go. So he's hitting on 3's with the Plague Slide. Those are 2 hits, and wounding on 3's... 1 wound, rend 1, onto the salamander.
So, a 5 up, goes to a 4, back to a 5.
And he drinks. Fly, blown, bite. D6 hits.
Bees.
5. We 5 bees. Here we go.
Slan's not here no more.
Hitting on 4's.
Oh, never mind.
Bees fly right into your mouth and become delicious.
I think bees are dying or something.
Yeah.
This is really between Doug and Jack.
Got a four.
Five! Ah, let's see if I screw this up.
Six, six.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Enemy is Doug. I love you, Katetsu. Here we go. So on a six, it's Chocolate Rain.
Acid Rain.
And then I'm going to do the Mega Boss's ability to make them go on a four, but they would have to charge. Nope, doesn't happen. Ooh, that's it. All right, now the movement. Okay.
Just put the dice down.
I don't have any dice.
Put the dice down.
I didn't want to make sure.
They only have 4-inch movement, so they're just going to go up here.
The dice don't really make noise anyways.
Now you're going to fall down.
Barrel of monkeys.
A little bit of breakdancing. That's what I like.
Break. Did everybody break?
No.
Okay.
I got a command point in my hero phase. So I have two because I used one last time for failing a charge. And so that's my movement. Now I'm going to charge. Doug's my enemy again.
Oh, no.
So these guys are going to charge. Come on. Big numbies. Seven.
Oh, okay.
Remember, plus one, you got.
Oh, extra eight. That's right, because I am a Uruk, Iron Jaw. All right. So, and now I'm going to use. Go into combat. Okay, start of the combat phase. Doug is the enemy again. And I'm going to use a Wah twice, because I have two good command abilities. So I'll roll for that.
Can orcs so count that high?
If they're barefoot. Alright, so now I need to roll.
Definitely not part of shoes.
Wah, there are two units here, so I have to roll a 1 or a 2. And for every 1 or 2 I roll, I get plus 1 attack for everybody. So I'm looking to roll low.
Oh! There it is! There it is!
I'm not re-rolling those ones.
No!
First with the Rip Tooth Fist, hitting on 5s, but I do get plus 2 attacks, so it's 4 attacks total now. Just one hit, wounding on 3s. That's one wound at a negative 2.
Okay, you 6 up.
Okay, no. And that is a D3 wounds. 2.
Okay, and so the scenery here for 6s. Nope. So that's him, and he has one wound left.
And then he's going with his boss, Chopra. I have 8 attacks now. And he's hitting on 3s.
Whoa.
Oh.
Wounding on 3s.
And rerolling once.
So that is a 6 and a negative 1.
Can you make me roll that? I'll get the 5 ups. No, he's super dead.
Rest in peace.
Okay.
It's smashing and bashing!
I destroyed a unit. Now I get to activate an Iron Jaw's unit with smashing and bashing. I'm going to activate the brutes, who get a bonus because there is a mega boss. So you can reroll hit rolls of 1 for friendly units of brutes that are within 5 inches of this model.
Yes.
Okay. Yes, they do have 6 attacks each.
6 attacks each.
So these are the guys who have the 2 brute choppers. They hit on 3s, wound on 3s, and minus 1 win, 1 damage, but I'm rerolling 1s to hit.
Shut the front door.
So I missed 2. And then wounding on 3s and a negative 1.
It's a good thing you got big hands.
Nobody can say 10, 11.
But it's true, you don't need to say anything at all.
Okay, looking for 6s. Yes, and then these also get the 6s from being near the terrain.
Yep.
Image.
5s or 6s?
6s.
6s, yeah, so I lose 3, 6, 7 dudes.
Oh, was that the Oz theme? With the Gore Choppa, hitting on 4s, rerolling 1s. So that's 4 hits, moving on 3s. It's 2 at a negative 1.
Okay, looking for 6s as well. Nope, and how much damage?
D3. So that is 4.
Okay. 3, that's enough to kill a unit.
Okay. I can't activate Smashing Bashing again, sadly.
Unit destroyed.
I did do 13 wounds,
yeah.
But that doesn't really. So I get 2 points.
Yeah.
Let's do it. The remaining 2.
6. I'm going to go ahead and take that. We're going to make this swift and brutal.
Swift and brutal, as KO do. Who wants to explain what's going on? Because I'm not smart enough to fall.
One thing we didn't realize is that when he moved the brutes in, he brought the Thunderers down here. If you could put the camera down here for me. Into combat, there's 3 inches there. And so they have this thing where they can activate and then choose to fall back rather than fight. So I'm actually going to go ahead and do that. So this is back up here. get myself out of 3 inches.
This is a term.
Still staying in good range. This way I can open up and shoot whatever I want rather than being engaged.
But this is a tournament. We don't do tournaments. We do silly. All right, let's give it a shot.
Kicking off the Carriage Overlord Hero phase, we're going to roll to see if I can get some rain coming down. No, it didn't happen. The chemist is going to go ahead and buff the weapon profile. They all have the ether rifles. And that'll pretty much conclude the hero phase, if I'm not mistaken. Jumping straight into the shooting phase.
Wait. What? Truce?
No, that's not going to happen.
Clearly Josh is a threat. He's going to sit back there and summon. We all need to stop him. He's just going to summon
himself. Settle down, fellas. There's a better way. Says the orc.
Hey, you know what? Hold up. See, that would have made a lot of sense if you would have turned around and came after me on your turn.
But that's not what happened.
Over there, you know what I'm saying? When you took your turn.
There's far too much gun violence.
You came in there and remembered the grudge between the orcs and the dwarves. You show came straight at
them. Put their weapons down.
Showed a little bit of old school hatred and went straight after them dwarves.
He shot me first.
We need more beer. This will solve this.
Now we're talking semantics.
I knew Josh was a threat. I know how he plays. That's why I didn't fight.
We were running out of the audio of them fighting.
Can't play soft.
Okay.
Right.
Okay. We're going to go with all of the Thunderers into the Mega Boss.
All right. Let's have it.
And so just in the shooting phase, my general declares a dude. Everyone gets to reroll hits against that. If they're within 3 inches, they are. And so these are going to be, let me get the profile pulled up.
I think they changed it to Holy Within, so you might have to...
Holy Within 3 inches?
Yeah, that's...
Hey, whatever, I still got with the bonuses and the leader getting extra attacks, this is everything I have, and they're going to be hitting on threes, so rerolling.
I hope you read the FAQ, because they got nerfed.
They did, thank you.
Just so you know, their stats have changed, and they only do D3 damage.
Turns out they cost 500 points of mana unit now. These are the rerolls. That was a pretty...
Pretty solid.
Pretty solid.
Good stuff.
These are all going to be wounding on fours.
Ooh.
And these are going to be at a minus one, so 3, 6, 9.
Oh, I'm out of mystical range, too.
Marie Kondo emailed and told me that those dice strike joy
I'm just gonna
in my heart.
Okay.
So minus one?
Yep.
Four up. 1, 2, 3. Ah, I got him.
Yes.
So this is important because, if you guys remember, my secret objective was to kill a enemy general. So that is an instant, I think, 3
I think
points.
When you asked us which ones are all our generals, we could tell that was your secret objective.
Subtlety is the art of fair
Akamornar. Look. Was that my general?
Yeah.
No reason.
No reason at all. The other attack that's going to be going off...
I'm still going.
Okay. It's going to be the Aether Chemist firing everything into the brutes, and his attack is pretty cool. It is 3d6 attacks. Okay.
It's like I will be making models shortly.
Boy!
You might just have to go take a nap for a little while.
So you've done 3 wounds. Maybe you'll get a few more points this
turn. Yeah.
Make sure there's nothing special about that.
He's doing math here.
Okay.
He's fully exhausted in the face, by
Because of his artifact, he gets plus one to hit, so he's going to be hitting on threes.
Hot steam.
That's a lot of twos. I'm not liking that.
That's okay.
That's a good consolation price. Winning on fours. Okay, so take 4 saves at a minus 2 rend.
Minus 2? You should have 4 up. So that's a 6.
They're going to cook in their armor.
Okay.
Oh my gosh.
And then it is 1 damage each.
Alright, these have 3 damage wounds each, so we'll do dead, and then I can't do it anymore.
Alright, for the mystical terrain.
Yep.
So Doug gets the point.
I get a point.
Battle shock.
Yep.
I'm good.
Good.
Is that it? For the battle shark?
That is it, yeah.
You didn't lose any guys.
Nope.
Yep.
Okay, cool. So, real quick, I forgot to mention, when I damaged the guy, my enemy, I got a victory point for damaging enemies. I'm sure people were reminding me in the comments section, so thank you. We're going to tally up here. Doug, did you get a victory point for doing a secret objective?
He got three. I did. I got three. And then I got an additional one because I did more than five wounds total, I believe.
Yep. So Doug is 5 points. You have two. Jack is two. Josh and I have zero. I get to go next. And you guys need to get new secret objectives, so don't let us see what you get.
Hashtag Nerf KO.
All right, this is rolling for the new secret objective, and we're doing good, we're doing good. See here, right there. Okay, everybody, shut up. Who's your general?
And this is Chu. I'm rolling for my new secret objective. I got that number, which is going to be this one.
Oh, you're right. Got that. All right, well, hero phase, I'm going to select Shu, Mark, as
me,
the enemy. Let's roll a six, or not. That's okay.
No.
So the rest
evil
of the hero phase, ruler of the spirit hosts. I'm within 9 inches of my general, so I'm going to bring back a spirit host model. And I have to place it within 9 inches. So
can it be outside of coherency?
No, it has to be
okay.
Coherency.
But he's good.
It has to be within. We're wholly within 9 of my dude. There we go.
Minty fresh.
That is the end of the hero phase, so I'm going to start moving. Or the movement phase, since I've got the Pendant of the Fell Winds, I'm getting +3 to my movement for anyone that starts wholly within 12 inches of him. So the Lord Executioner will get to move 9.
Nice.
He will also get to move 9. The Drezai Herodians were outside, so they're actually gonna run this way. Oh man.
They're just an inch.
An inch. They're moving back around here. Wanna go for. So the one thing I'm excited about though is Light Kings do have lots of wounds. So if I can start doing wounds, I can start getting points.
Your tacos are ready.
I guess then we can go right into charge phase.
Let's do it.
So here goes the charge phase. I am selecting Shu as my enemy. First, let's try charging with the Spirit Host.
That's 8 inches.
Eight. And he can fly.
Yeah.
Which is cool. So he'll go right up there.
Aegis Ingmar doesn't care.
How about Lord Executioner? 7. Yeah.
He's in.
And he will fly over that guy's head and just land right with him.
Do you do mortal wounds when you fly over people?
I don't. I'm not a hex wraith.
Not a hex wraith, okay.
Not a sequel.
Combat phase, I'm going to select Shu as my enemy, and I'm going to activate the Spirit Torment first. So with his Shacklegeist chains, he's hitting on 4s, rerolling 1s from Bidding of Nagash. So I got 2 hits, he's wounding on 3s. I've got 2 wounds, and there's -2 rend on there.
Oh my gosh. So that's 6s.
So no. It's going to go through their D3 damage each.
Oh,
for 6 damage, how many Morbid Vigors can you make?
Let's see. It looks like about 1.
I am on the board with doing 5 wounds.
Nice.
Ooh, you can't pile that guy that way.
Pile in.
Closest enemy model to him.
Oh, right, right.
They're different colors, so we got confused.
Yeah. So this guy can't go, and this guy can't go. He can go that way, but I don't want to break coherency. This guy can go that way, but this is the closest model here.
No, not anymore.
Well, yeah, since he's not an enemy model.
Oh, right.
They're
all enemies.
There's stuff everywhere. Who knows? Who knows even how to play the game?
So I'm actually stuck in this position thanks to the special rules of Triumph and Treachery.
But you've got 2 guys who are in contact, and who do they...
Yeah. Oh, I got him.
Oh, cool.
He's in range.
And that guy's in range to fight the Chainrass over here.
Very cool. Yeah, so we'll do the Chainrass first, just get him out of the way.
Is that what they mean to you?
That's what you get
when you underestimate.
Okay, now these 2 guys are going to go into... Well, this guy's going to have to go here into the...
Spirit Host.
Spirit Host. Here we go. Hitting on 3s. 6s are special. This is 6.
Another 6?
Oh, another 6.
Oh my goodness. 8
right, more
hits. Everybody's paying attention to this.
Not going
to
be sad.
It's a little combat.
Not going to be sad if you
take here we go. It's going to be winning on 3s.
All wounds.
Oh, my goodness. Seven? Well, here we go. We've got some 4-up saves from Ethereal coming. Well, you don't have rend anyway. However, now I've got... Okay, there's 5. There's going to be a point unless I can make one of these 6s for Deathless Spirits. No! So I'm going to take 5 damage. That's going to kill this guy 1-2.
And then 3, 4, 5. Yeah, I'm going to take that one. So another point for Shu. And then you still have one more Blight King, right?
That's what you get for killing the boss.
I guess.
Well, so this is going to go on to your heavy axe.
Lord Executioner?
Yeah. Axe Handler.
From everybody that watched Skirmish, yes. Tenebra and the Undaunted.
All five of you.
Tenebra.
Yeah.
This is awesome.
Yeah, you know this guy.
Thanks,
you know
Mom, for watching Skirmish. Okay, three tags. On threes. Sixers is special. No sixes. And then threes, two wound. So that's two wounds, no rend.
So we go with four up saves. He makes him bold.
Don't
hey,
care.
You remember that?
Yeah, he cannot die. And as you saw, Brent Chesme is his enemy last round, so I get another victory point for doing damage. I have to roll for my new secret objective real quick. This is Shu rolling for the secret objective.
I don't want to keep giving you points.
Yes. It's this one.
Lord Executioner is swinging back with his decapitating great axe. He's hitting on threes.
Ooh.
He is wounding on threes, and sixes are going to be plus two damage. Nope, so he's just going to get one wound, but it's negative two rend.
All right, so on a six, no. And on a five for the vigor, no.
Just a single damage.
1 point.
So I'm going to pile in the Spirit Host. And these are the enemy models, so I can just ignore that guy right there. I've got three attacks. I do a mortal wound. That's it.
Nice. And I'm going to try Shurgen on a five up. I don't.
You're...
I'm going to take a wound. I'd like to point out that Brent is literally Skyrim here. Like, he's...
It makes more sense than the horse. Come on.
Yeah.
It's not that janky, right? I've got four guys in contact with the Blight Kings, so I will be hitting on fours and rerolling ones because of...
What?
I'm now wholly within 12 for bidding of Nagash. Ooh, very good. And now I am... Winning on fours. Let me reroll that. Okay, so I've got two ones. How many do have I lost anybody here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. I have lost one model, so I don't get Chilling Horde. I just got a single wound with no rend.
Okay, so four up? Fine.
Hey, next time keep building more flat terrain shoes.
Yeah, really, I gotta do that. Okay, so this math hammer here. We actually determined that my Harbinger of Decay is able to pile in.
This guy's sort of like here.
Yeah.
We're doing some real abstraction here, so let's just be generous and say everybody's fighting.
It's
and
basically he can, here, yeah.
You know.
But
sure.
Yeah.
Sure.
Brent, my Harbinger of Decay is going to try to hit you with this scythe attack. Threes and threes. And then threes. Nothing. But now bees. Oh, bees and bees. Is... One bee dice.
Let's say six fours. Damage right here.
No.
Nope. Well,
okay.
Completely whiffed.
Yes. Yeah. All right.
Okay, we are going to recap because it turns out Josh got a victory point.
Yeah, when I attacked up here, I was supposed to attack somebody with more victory points than me. So I did a wound. So that was Shu. So now I'm going to go ahead and re-roll.
Your new, new triumph.
My new secret objective.
Re-roll battle shuttle.
Panning across the battlefield, we're taking a stock of everyone's victory points. So I am in the lead with 5. Jack has 2. Josh has 2. Shu, over here with the Nurgle stuff, has 4.
Whoa!
And Brent has a gentleman's 1.
Hey, the cycle of contagion has cycled. We now are landing on the burgeoning. Roll a dice for each unit within 1 inch. Oh, wait, no. We had that last turn.
No,
now on the plague of misery. Thank you, Nurgle. Get it to my level, Nurgle. Reroll Battleshock tests of 1 for enemy units, excluding Nurgle units. Super player, roll off.
I get the robot dice because I'm in last.
3. 5. Roll the 5.
The
it's there. Proof. Proof. Show them.
You want to give it to me, Jay?
There it goes. No. Iron Jaws. So, it is Iron Jaws. I don't have a hero, but since we are playing open play, if your general does die, you have to select a new hero to be a general, but I don't have a hero, so...
Yeah, we're playing 500 points, everybody, so settle down.
I do get to do the Steel Rain, Rust Rain, whatever the rain is.
On a 6.
The rain's down.
Oh, he was the enemy, but...
Yeah.
That's fine. Okay, that is it for my hero phase.
You want to go right to other stuff?
Yeah, I'm just going to go straight to movement. I'm going to be outside of three over here. They have a movement of
double
four.
Double
so.
Ones. Double ones.
Oh, you still get it because you're flipping iron jaws. It don't matter.
Double. Yeah.
Well, if he gets double ones, he fails.
Why?
Why?
Because then you charge 3 inches.
Yeah, yeah. That's right.
Okay, to be, you're 1 centimeter away.
Okay. Oh, wait, no. Do you get? Yeah, never mind.
So, Iron Jaw gets...
That's all good.
Ignore me.
Yeah.
I'm out.
This guy doesn't know anything.
Brett literally
last
left.
Place. What do I... Brett...
Excellent. So I'm going to move.
You can wrap around behind.
But it is what it is. Can I put my... I'm not going to do that, Joel. All right. Can I stack my bases? So we're going with the Gore Chopper. It has a 2-inch range, so I'm going to hit the chemist because he's brutal. And he has more than four wounds or more, so I get to reroll hits.
Hit this is what you get for cooking meth in my neighborhood.
2 hits. It helped me. Wounding on 3s. Just 1 and a -1.
Okay, looking for a 5 up.
Ooh. D3. 2.
2.
Take it. Take that. No, then now it's all on your fenders now.
Okay.
So the Boss Claw is a special rule.
Yes, if I hit with the Boss Claw, his other weapon automatically hits. But the Boss Claw hits on 4s. Only 1 attack. Hits.
Nice.
Wounds on 3s. Wounds at a -1.
5 up.
Ooh.
Nails it.
But the other one still hits.
Yep.
And he's going to bang you like a drum.
And now it's the Boss Chopper. Or no, it's the
Boss
Boot
Smasher.
So already hit. Wounding on 3s. 2 and a -2.
Okay, looking for 6s. Nope, nothing.
Okay, and it's D3. So that is a 5.
Ooh.
Boop.
No, I'm not in range for the terrain thing anymore.
Brutes have a great showing with that. Oh my gosh.
And I can't do anything else.
Yeah, because everyone's out of combat now.
7 wounds, so I get a point.
You do?
Let's spare the comment section some rage.
Yeah, so I just realized that the chemist also has the atmospheric isolation, which basically means that everyone around me, within 3 inches, all the enemies would be -1 attack. So that would have affected the combat here. I'm going to say it doesn't matter because after his boss dude deleted that entire unit himself, he would have had 2 more guys to go in there.
Yeah.
And they were not long for this world, so let's just skip that. That's okay. But he's going to pile in. He's going to go towards the terrain over here. He's got 2 attacks. These are going to be on 3s because artifact, +1 to hit. They're going to be wounding on 4s, which is nothing at all.
Choke lung.
Choke lung. Here we go. Ready? Good. What? Bop.
3.
Ooh.
6. Brent. Now I'm going to go next.
Choose E.
Nighthaunt hero phase. You're the enemy. I hate you.
Le gasp!
Let's see if I can roll a 6 and dump some
rain on.
Yeah!
Rain on my parade. I'm in cover, but I'm not in cover.
Yeah, you're not.
Okay, so you can do it here if you want to.
I'm going
to
do it here, actually, just because I want to try and clean up here. So I've got 4 Blight Kings, and so I need to roll less than they're saved. They've got a 4-up save, so we're going 1, 2s, and 3s. Do mortal wounds. I got 1 mortal wound. Do you want to try and deflect that with Morbid Vigor?
Here we go. Morbid Vigored.
So morbid.
Morbid.
Very vigorous!
Vigorous.
Much bigger.
I have 3 command points. I'm going to use one because I think we all know that for me to think that I'm going to score this is just kind of arrogant at this point. So rerolling that. You know what? can I do this again? Can I do this again? Let me take a look. All right, command point number 2. There's nothing that says a dog can't play basketball. All right, rerolling. Yeah. We'll go with that one.
Ruler of the spirit hosts. I'm going to bring back D3 spirit hosts.
Or 3.
The other 2 are coming back. Movement phase. I've still got the Dread Scythe Heritans over here. So they're gonna fly over the trees. They have a very important mission.
To stop these guys from charging a general into the butt?
Dun, 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 dun,
no, I want to kill that guy. Okay. So we can just go right into charges then. You're the enemy. So
who's charging?
The Dread Scythe Heritans.
The Dread Scythe Heritans, yes.
Okay.
The only one's not in combat. No.
Six.
Well, maybe.
Oh, yeah. No.
Straight line, right?
Absolutely, yeah. So they will fly up here and make it in.
Into the mosh pit.
Start of the combat phase. I'm selecting Shu, and I'm going to use my Dread Scythe Heritance to try and attack the general. Again, the hill is super goofy, so all five of them are in contact. They're hitting on fours with their side limbs, re-rolling ones to hit because of Bidding of Nagash.
Do my bidding!
Ooh, I bid it!
That was pretty good.
That's... I'll take it.
You!
So now they're wounding on threes, and sixes are going to do two damage instead of one. Which I get no sixes. So there's,
what a wonderful rule when it comes up.
There's a six, and they're negative one rent.
All right, let's roll these dice.
Go for it.
This is the moment to roll like Shu.
Three up.
Well, and I've got negative one rent, so you're
four. So four up, yes. So here, here, here.
Well, right, so it goes 4, 2, 3. And then back to four.
And then back to four, right.
Yep, yep.
Right.
Yep.
So that's fast, but this is Morbid Vigor here. And so I'm taking two wounds.
Resilient.
Okay, I'm going to choose to go with my Vikings now. The these two guys are going to pile into the
chain rasps,
and they are going to. I've got six dice here.
What you got in your pocket?
Yes, threes and threes, but sixers are special to hit.
Get your hand out my pocket.
Okay, that goes away, and then threes.
I am glad that none of our special abilities are activating.
Exactly, yeah.
I've got five up saves on the chain rasps. Two are going to go through, but then I've got deathless spirits on sixes, ignoring those wounds. No, I'm taking two.
Okay, this guy's going to hit this unit. I'm going to see if... I can't wipe him, but I got to try.
Mm-hmm.
Here we go.
I mean, they only have nine wounds total.
Yeah,
so...
Both of these guys. You know what? Both of those guys are going to go to that unit.
Do it.
Right. I'm sick of their... Sick of their coming back.
Go for
it. I'm going to hit you so hard you're not coming back. Okay.
Aren't they just giving you points?
Sixes are special.
You're not going to do it with that, dude.
Yeah, no, that's not going to happen. Two of them are going to hit, though, and wound on threes.
And a four up save.
Crank it. Who cares?
We're going to make you so bored you never come back.
Spirit Torment is going to attack with his Shackle Guy's Chains, attacking the Blight Kings, hitting on fours, rerolling ones from the Bidding of Nagash.
The Padlocks of Love.
Oh, see, his own ability. And he's wounding on threes. Now I got two wounds, negative two rend.
Sixes on the Blight Kings.
Ah,
yeah.
Very nice. And then fives.
Oh, I got my D3 damage. For three. What you got?
I get three fives.
No.
So two more wounds. However, that does kill a Blight King. So, and put a wound on another guy. So we're going to ratchet that over here and take this Blight King out of combat. Last but not least, the Harbinger of Decay is going to hit this Dread Scythe Heritage, make them pay for coming up this hill. This is my hill. Get off my hill. Scythe attack. Hitting on threes.
No,
wow. Hitting on threes. That's one.
And a four up ethereal. Nope.
D3 damage. For three.
Ooh, let me take a look.
Okay. That was a really good zoom in his arm.
Still with the devil spirits. Sixes. No, three Dreadscythe Heritage are toast.
Nice. What about bees? Are they allergic to bees? Bee attack from the horse. Fly blown bite for four dice. I just happen to have four in my hands hitting on fours.
Ooh.
Wounding on fours.
Watch these ones. The nader's out.
Yeah, nothing.
Lord Executioner is up next with his decapitating great axe, hitting on threes.
Oh, we need our heads.
Rerolling ones from Bidding of Nagash.
Mm-hmm.
He's wounding on threes, and the six is going to be two damage.
Yeah,
so,
he is.
They're both negative two rend. Mark, roll these separately because one is cooler than the other.
Oh.
So I'm glad you failed that one, and you failed both of them. So that's going to be four damage.
See, four or five ups. For the vigor. No, I just got one, so three damage total.
Cool. So
it's going to kill the next guy.
That's brought me up to seven, so I'm going to score 1 point for that.
Yeah, dude.
And I'm also, my secret objective, going to score counterattack, inflict one or more wounds on a unit from the army of the player that has more victory points than you or the same number of victory points. So I'm going to be adding three to my total, and I'm going to roll for another secret objective.
So because between like getting that one and the one you got from doing damage, you swung way back up, right?
I should be at four now.
Yeah. Four so. To Mark's five.
Cooking.
Yeah. Let me roll up. Okay, so I need a new one. You generate them immediately. Oh, so okay.
Oh, thank you.
When you did salty. Okay, chain rats are going to attack Blight Kings. They're hitting on fours with their malignant weapons, rerolling ones.
But they get none of those. They're wounding on fours. I got one wound on Blight Kings, who now have cover, by the way.
And they crank it.
And they're totally fine.
They don't care.
Battle Shock.
And I'm choosing Shu is the enemy for the Battle Shock phase, so he takes my negative one.
All right, Battle Shock for the mortals. So just I'm minus three to my bravery, effectively.
Well, so you're normally bravery eight, and then you're negative one from the Sinister Train. You're negative another one from the Nighthaunt Allegiance ability. So you're down to six, and then you've lost two models. So fives and sixes, no.
Don't care. Lots of math, but that's why they call it aftermath.
Let's go right here, because it's camera.
Well, and then there were three.
Five.
Josh out of six.
What are you thinking, Josh?
I was just going to take it.
I was like, still got two guys over here that have just been largely ignored as Nurgle and Nighthaunt have just started slapping each other in the face.
You let me go. I don't know if that was recorded or not. But yeah, we're going to just ace through this stuff real quick. Let's go for that Realmscape feature. On a six.
No! You didn't say who's your enemy. Who's your enemy?
Oh, I'm sorry. Yeah, Jack is my enemy. Oh, if you didn't know, it's kind of a reoccurring theme.
I think you should
re-roll. It's a good rivalry.
You can't roll a six and then decide.
So how does it work? You have to roll below their wounds characteristic?
Below their their save, yeah.
Okay.
So one, twos, and threes.
Boom!
You got some guy. Yeah.
Yeah, everybody, you guys are with range, so I will roll. I need sixes.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so thank you, Mystical Terrain.
It's been pretty good this round.
Yep.
This game, I mean.
Moved down.
Yeah, he had one wound on him, right?
Yeah, he had one wound. So
two. So then that guy's taking a wound.
I'll put it over here on this guy.
Cool. Yeah. And Doug, what are you going to do in your hero phase?
Well, the chemist is going to buff his own gun.
Cool.
So he gets plus one attack. It's 3d6 plus one. So that should be good. I think that's pretty much it for the hero phase. So movement, he's still within three, even though Jack pulled the guy away. And so, charging, no shooting. He does have his 3d6 mega gun. It's this plus one.
Low, low, low.
Six, seven, eight, nine, 10 shots total.
Oof. That's enough to kill the whole unit.
Is that going to happen? Okay. These are going to be three up because of his artifact. Rerolling because he chose that unit in the shooting phase. It's the only one in front of him. So, three ups, rerolling.
Oof, come on, low, low. Oh, just one miss, I'm pretty sure.
And these are all going to be fours to wound.
Oof.
Oof.
And it's going to be minus one save.
Okay, so I have four up, going to five up.
Minus two.
Six up. Okay. Ooh,
very nice.
Why?
Uh-huh. So that's four damage?
Yes.
Yep.
All right, I moved it over there, so I can't use Mystical Terrain because I'm
carrying
them. So one, two, three. No, the one, two. And then two more, I'll put on him. So he has one left. Oh.
Going into melee, he's going to pile in here, and he's piling in specifically to make sure he gets near that terrain, because it's been so relevant. And so we got two attacks. He's going to be hitting on threes, rerolling. You don't need that.
Ooh.
Wounding on fours.
Oh, nothing.
Yeah, that's all there is to it.
We'll be getting minus one attack. We remembered it because his smoke clouds. So this is the boss claw hitting on fours. Oh, and so my other one attack now only hits automatically from the boss chopper. No, the Bruce Masher, excuse me. This is for the boss claw, wounded on threes at a minus one.
Okay, looking for five.
Nope. And that is boss claw is two damage.
Okay, so he has one wound remaining.
Oh, you have the mystical tree.
Oh, you're right. You said two damage?
Yep.
Sixes, nope. One remaining.
Excellent. Now I will go with the Bruce Masher, which is already hit to wound on three. Wound at negative two.
All right, looking for a six. Nope, and then...
D3. Just one.
Mystical Terrain?
No! Sorry.
You bring him down.
He's brought
him
super down. Dead.
And guess what my... the secret objective. When I kill a general, I get 3 points.
Cool. So you're scoring three. Now, the Battle Shock phase, though... On a five or six, you're out of here.
The auto pass. so
this is big.
Six minus two. I'm at four. Yay!
Oh, Iron Jaws, hang on.
I would have paid money for that. We just all kill each other in the corner.
Going for my new secret objective. I'm still in the game.
Dicing off with the remaining players here.
5 to a 6!
Yeah. Woo! You get to decide again.
Let's look here. What's going on there?
Yeah, because, man, they ain't really... See, the inner, you know, hey, you seen my secret objective. You know what my problem is right now. So, you know...
I love this passionate call to the viewers. I love it.
I'm going
to
go ahead and let you go.
All right, that's it.
I did nothing to deserve this. All I did was fight Doug.
Well, I can't do it here. Voice.
He
called
my name like 6 times.
All right, everybody.
Like, we're tight. I'm about to leave, drink one of those, and go join 2+ stuff. And now this guy's kicking me out the door.
As we understand...
The door hits you on the ass on the way out, Jack. Here we go.
Well, hold on. As we understand...
It's a 1. It doesn't matter.
Okay, it wasn't... Okay, I was going to say, as we understand this rule, for generating contagion points... It's if there are enemy models in the same territory as Nurgle models, then you're not getting that additional plus one. But if you select somebody else in the hero phase that's not here, you get another plus one, maybe? Sure. So
I understand. It was the only choice.
Because I destroyed Doug.
There was only one choice. True. I understand. You're forgiven.
It's true. That's true.
So how many contagion points do you get?
There's 3 here for this thing.
Yeah.
For this zone, 3.
Well, 4, because nobody else is there.
Yeah, 4. Because nobody else here. I would have got 1 here for having a Nurgle model outside.
But you would have got 3.
But we didn't because I failed that roll, right?
No. So you, hold on.
Okay, after much arguing and bickering, we determined that I have 8 contagion points plus 2d3 for each of these trees. Let's see those 2d3.
Ooh.
4, 5, 6, 7.
So that's 13 in addition to what did you have before?
There was
6.
6 on there before, I think.
Cool.
I
just made the number up.
I'll look at the dice. Okay.
Well, either way,
4 and then 2.
You got some points.
Hero phase, I'm using Morbid Vigor for my command ability. Then I'm going to go right into my movement phase. I'm going to run these guys. We're going to go as far as they want to go.
Wow.
And then we're just going to make sure to keep a guy within 7 inches for the tree so he can charge at the end of that. Brent, I have placed these beautiful Nurglings that a dear friend of mine painted into my home objective, and that way I can keep that and still charge and pile in.
Very clever.
Sir, we have some charges. Would you like to charge that to your
room?
Are
you saying that I'm the enemy?
I'm going to say that you're the enemy, because I don't think I can make it to him or this.
So these two lone dinosaurs? Yeah.
Well, they're kind of like irrelevant. At this point, they're just stumps.
Yeah, watch when that guy dumps D6 damage on us.
Celestial stumps. That are going to hemorrhage my brain.
Nasty, nasty Blight Kings.
In the combat phase, I'll declare Chain Raster, the Nighthaunt, is my enemy, instead of the dinosaurs who we're just kind of all ignoring.
Rude.
It is rude. Here, hitting on 3s.
Uh-oh.
That's all them hit, and these are special.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Not that big of a deal.
I mean, 10 is better than 3.
That was a 2.
That was 2, yeah. 10 is better than 3.
That's true.
Just so you know,
more dice out.
Charlie Brown just has a pocket full of dice here, and he's just like...
Well, Jack's like, keep the table clear of stuff, and I'm like, okay, that's a good idea.
You're like a dealer, though. You've just got, like...
I have a burrito in here, and I have, like, a slice of pizza.
Well, I'm thinking of the fan, sorry. It breaks the immersion.
That was a good idea. That's a good idea, but I have to keep pizza in my pocket now. Okay, wounding on 4s, or 3s. What am I attacking? I should...
Chain rats. No, it's chain rats, boys.
Look at that crap.
Yeah.
Charlie Brown.
I'll take these. 5 up.
Who the hell did I hit?
The chain rasboard. And the 6s. Okay, so 3 of them. Go bye bye.
Oh no.
He's flying up there, by the way.
How many hit rolls did he roll?
Oh, a lot of hits.
He hit it with everything, but then 3 of them exploded to make.
So did he roll 6 dice to hit?
Yep. Mm-hmm.
Okay, it was just 6. Okay, I thought maybe you were attacking with them into the chain rash.
That's what
yeah. No, he hasn't gone full shoot.
No.
Okay. Yeah, okay. No, that was just 2 guys. Spirit Torment's gonna turn around and he's gonna shackle guys, chain these Blight Kings in the face. He's sitting on 4s, rerolling 1s.
Shackle guys, chain me in the face when you.
Okay. 3's a wound. Hey, there's 2 wounds at -2 rend.
6s. Don't make those 6s.
2d3.
Oh,
he's in the
6 dice.
Twice. 6 damage.
Spear Torment, best close combat character.
Here we go.
You can do it.
Five ups. I save two, but I lose a almost lose a guy.
You don't lose a guy.
Yeah, because the leader is an extra point.
Yeah.
The leader, however, is in the middle, stupidly. Oh, so I'll have to figure him out. No, I think I'm just going to take the guy. Yeah. Nope.
No.
I'm going to take the leader, because I'll pile. I'll pile in.
He's not dead yet, though.
He's not dead. He took five.
He took four.
Oh, took four. You guys are great, because I have a brain of a potato.
Secret objective scored! Retribution. Inflict one or more wounds on a unit from the army of the player that last chose you as an enemy. So I'm going to get 2 points.
Look away.
And what am I going to get? Very cool. King of the Hill continues. Yeah.
we're gonna fight down here this time, though. These three gentlemen are going to hit this sad man carrying his own noose. Here we go.
That's for you.
Hitting threes. Sixes are special.
Oh, three sixes?
Oh, no.
Did last time. Misses. And the rest are... that's history. These are going to be what?
It just...
Oh! Triple six.
14 hits is scary.
Okay, so five...
And remember, everybody, nobody could kill him in skirmish. Nobody's gonna kill him here.
Okay, wounding on threes.
Not bad.
There you go, Brent.
Four up saves, followed by six up. Deathless Spirits. Okay, well, he's not gonna die. That's cool. But sixes. But he's gonna take four wounds. He is down to a single wound.
Oh, so close.
Whoa.
Sorry.
No, it's fine. Two more Blight Kings.
So these two guys are going to go against this hero here.
Oh, the Spirit Tormox.
That's right.
Big locks.
Big locks. Here we go. Sixers is special. I got two of those sixes. I'm going to roll those real quick.
I love how you roll six or two. Like, okay, well, never mind.
Yeah.
There you go, back.
That's kind of all I do right now.
You replace the ones you missed.
Yeah, that's right. So...
Four.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Like, I did the math. But the dice say things.
The dice say things.
Two.
Well, here's four ups on Mr.
Nope.
No. And six up Deathless Spirit save. Nope, he has taken two wounds as well. So that's bringing Shu has done 9 damage total. It's getting close to that 2 victory points.
He's got a couple wounds on him.
Shred Scytherians are going to attack the Harbinger of Decay. They are hitting on fours, rerolling ones from Bidding of Nagash. Yuck, I got two. Wounding on threes and sixes are 2 damage, so there's a 2 damage and a 1 damage, both -1 rend.
So, 4 up here,
mm-hmm.
becomes a 3 up, becomes a 4 up, because they cover, make it, and then 4 up
you
there.
Make it. Shut down.
Alright, we're going to do those, hit the Scythe Herodons back.
And going with for the scythe. Extra victory points.
The Scythe Herodons with the scythe. Hitting on threes, wounding on threes. Flies. How do you feel about bees? It's gonna be 2 bee dice.
It's enough to kill me.
Fours?
No. Not enough to kill me.
Okay, so just one.
Lord Executioner. He is going to attack the Blight Kings. He's got 2 hits. He needs 3s to wound. He's got 1 wound, and it's -2 rend.
Out of the Blight Kings. Sixes. And then fives. Oh wait, how much damage is it?
Just one. Okay, so that's my 5 damage. I'm going to get a point for that.
Oh, man. I have to take it off this guy in the middle. That sucks. Womp womp.
Chain Rasp attacking Blight Kings. They are rerolling ones from Pitting of Degash. Not happening. So I got 4 hits. Wounding on fours. I got 3 wounds. And 2 are going through, and then Morbid Vigor.
Morbid Vigor.
Oh, just one.
Save one, just one. And that's going to go onto a guy who's going to die in a run anyways. Put that over...
Oh, it's on this unit.
Okay. At least it's not going to happen.
And then I guess I can...
Do stuff?
Pile in.
Yeah, okay, so this guy... Oh, he couldn't move, actually. So that guy, this Spirit Host can attack these Blight Kings. This Spirit Host can attack these Blight Kings. So on this unit, there's a Mortal Wound and one other wound.
Okay, the Mortal Wound, I could heal it on a 6. Or not take it on a 6. Or a 5, sorry. Because of Vigor, but it goes through.
And then the regular wound, you're actually getting a 3-up save because you're in cover. And you're okay. Now these, on this unit of Blight Kings, one Mortal Wound... And one other wound. Same thing.
Okay. Saving throw. Make one, take one. And for the one I took, 5-up. No.
Just one wound then.
So that's the end here. For Battleshock, I'm picking Shu. Now he's not... Yeah.
Yep.
The boss.
These guys are terminated at the end of the round because I had to remove a model from the middle, taking them out of currency.
That happens because, after Battleshock, so
yeah,
it doesn't go against you.
So, but they did lose a guy, but I can't feel it because of the... Oh, wait, I can feel it because of all the minuses here. If I roll a 5 or 6, I can feel it.
Yeah, actually. Well, you lost one, so your 8 would become a 7, and then you're down to 6 because of Nighthaunt Spooky, so no, you're okay.
And 5...
Well, how close do you have to be to that?
An inch. And oh, this guy would still be here.
Oh, I was? Okay, so you're right. Yeah. So, roll dice. Okay, no, you're fine. Okay, but then they leave after Battleshock.
Well, he rolled a 1, doesn't guys come? So, in the hero phase, I'm going to pick Brent, and I'm going to do, what are those, Chain Rasps?
Chain Rasps. Yeah,
and there's a...
Yeah, I'm going to do...
Well, Chain Rasps, he might wipe him out, because there's only 4 left, and they only have 5 up saves. So, do you get the 6? We got to roll 1 dice.
One dice.
Oh. Yeah. Yeah, jump right. Right, here we go.
Do they get rained on?
Nope. Oh, no.
Oh, it's okay.
So I conjure the 3 times, which gives me 10 points, because I have a slant general out there, and so now I have 2 left over, so that puts me at 12. And that is it for my hero phase. All right, I'm going to Lords of Space and Time. We're going to start... Right here.
The newly minted Sunblood.
5, and you can move after, yes.
Very cool.
We're going to end up right there.
There he is. Is anyone else rolling? Because you can do it twice, right?
Yes, I can do it twice. So now I'm going to see about that salamander. Nope, he's stuck there.
That's okay. Nobody knows he's there anyway.
Can he shoot and attack and nothing like that, right?
Oh, he can.
He can shoot.
Oh, he can still shoot. Yeah. Stuff? Okay.
Movement phase.
I just love how they completely ducked out of just this mess.
Slan's gonna run.
They want him to be alone.
Contemplate the cosmos or
spawning new lizard. Nobody knows how.
New battle tone this year? We're gonna get an answer? I don't know.
He's gonna run.
They're over there swimming in the spawning pools, getting into each other's juices.
Gross.
So he can move after being summoned.
But what's happening over here? Sword's guard back on the battlefield.
Shu is my enemy for this shooting phase.
He's angered the listeners.
I'm going to shoot at the Harbinger with the salamander.
You hit him.
It's a hit. And 3-1.
Yep.
That's a 1.
And there's this Blight King unit only has 2, so he doesn't get lookout, sir.
No lookout, sir. So
if there was, I still would.
Shu, you got a 5-up save because after this -2 rend.
Oh, just 1?
Just 1.
Oh no.
But it's D6 damage.
Let's see it.
Alright.
For 4.
4 damage.
Okay, so this guy has 2 wounds left.
Oh no, sorry, it's him.
Oh, yeah. It kills my general.
No, you got Morbid Vigor.
You got Morbid
Vigor. Can you save him?
Ooh.
Yes. Oh, yes, it's still alive.
Got 2 wounds left.
2 wounds left. It's not over. It's not over.
At the end of the shooting phase, anybody who takes wounds from his acid can, it burns. So if I roll a 4 up, it's D3 mortal wounds. Nope. Oh, wait, hold on.
I mean, that's...
Nah, but...
I would have taken it.
No.
Okay.
Dodge phase, my enemy is going to be my brother. Because am I my brother's keeper? No, I am not.
You saw what happened the last time. Yeah.
Here we go.
He's over there.
On the charge. Six.
Sitting there.
Yeah, look at that. So now in the combat phase, Jack is my enemy. So for my bite, it's forced to hit.
One hit.
And that,
Rook.
That is,
Does that go for his bite as well?
Yeah, it goes for his attacks.
Oh, so it's D3 hits?
It's D3 hits, but a Ferocious Rage or something. Okay, so Ferocious Rage, so that'll be D3.
Three?
So three bite attacks. Four is to wound.
Three?
Oh,
two.
And two.
And
you're in? No rend.
Okay, one save. Oop, he's dead.
They both stand alone.
Now, I got five attacks with my War Mace. Three is the hit. And three is the wound. Okay. And that's D3 damage.
Okay, what's the rend?
Rend is minus one.
Alright, saved it. Whew. Oh, I get to attack back.
Yeah.
Bully. So, Boss Claw, hitting on fours. Got it. But I have Death of the Big Things, I do get to reroll misses. And wounding on threes. Nope. The other thing already hits, so we're wounding on threes. Two at a minus one.
Okay.
Seven, sure, the Brute Smash isn't negative two rend?
Oh, yeah, you're right. Mm-hmm. Negative two rend.
I ignore up to negative three rend.
That's correct.
Nice.
So
a giant shield.
Yeah, for the shield at Aeon or whatever. So here we go, and
yep, good
save
go.
Both of them.
Okay. Oh, I'll run on a six.
Right. Here we go. Turn four.
Three, six, Josh.
Josh, it's your choice.
Now keep in mind, this could be the last turn of the game unless we roll a six.
Alright, I get to go first. Alright, I don't have anything to do.
But you got hero phase.
Yes, nothing in my hero phase.
You got
enemy
rain.
Go ahead, roll that rain.
Metal rain.
I will pick, we'll go with Brent.
Oh,
boom.
Feel it.
Boom. I have to.
Oh.
Six.
Oh! Which unit do you want
to
do?
I'm going to try to finish off the. I have to roll lower than a four, right? I'm going to finish off the Dread Scythe Herodians.
Okay, so that's lower than a three because they've got a four up save.
So a three?
Yep.
So if you pick the one, Chain Rasp, you probably get rid of
it. Yeah, I'm going to try the.
Okay, so there's four Chain Rasps left. One through fours are mortal wounds.
Oh, just two mortal wounds.
All right, and I can deflect them on sixes. Yeah, Jack can't roll. Okay, so. Goodbye.
Okay, so that was my hero phase.
That's my hero phase, yeah.
I think I've got that twice. No, just once. Pile. I'm going to pile in like this.
Oh, nice. And going for the cover. You got the high. What does Obi-Wan say?
I've got the high ground.
You did.
Mm-hmm.
I am going to hit on fours, rerolling with my Boss Claw. Miss.
I'm gonna come back over here.
Nope, missed it.
No!
Right. Boom smashes. Rerolling. no, I need a four for the boot smash.
What happened to this guy?
What happened? You know what? I just realized I can't do that.
You can't?
Because I have to be closer, and
Or closer.
Yeah, closer. I don't think I'm in terrain.
Okay.
I don't
think All right. Sure. We got mystical terrain. Josh, you wanna try and smash this guy?
Let's try the bites.
Mm-hmm.
Four is the hit. Threes.
One. Saved it.
Okay. Now he's got five with his mace attack. Three is the hit. Sixes do
D3 hits. Oh, three. There's three. Negative one.
-1.
Five up. I take three damage. This could kill me off. I need 1-6. Oh, oof.
He is defeated.
No longer standing.
We got three players left to roll off. Oh. What are you doing? What do you want to do? Do you want to go next?
Yeah, I'll go next, man.
Cool.
I'm going to try to dump right on Josh my hero phase on a 6. I get it. I do.
Oh.
All right.
Pick a unit.
Which one has a higher save?
Oh, wait, no. We forgot. If you're in cover.
Yeah.
Oh, you can. Okay. Oh, yeah. Well, I can do it here.
Yeah, you love those guys.
You can do or it here. There.
Do it here.
Yeah, there you go.
What's his save?
His save is a 4.
Right. Yeah. And it only does 4. A single mortal wound.
So I roll 2 dice or just 1?
It would just be 1.
Separate. So you roll 1 die, pick either one.
Okay. This guy.
Got him.
What's his save for it?
Yep.
Okay, yeah, I deal a mortal wound.
I did a thing, everybody. Woo! I sniped him with rain.
Oh, we forgot to turn this, but that's going to hurt me.
Okay, I have 3 contagion points from before. Is that what it is, contagion points?
Yep.
And I get 8 this turn, and then 2d3, 1 for each of the trees. So d3 here for 3, d3 here.
2.
For 2.
Cool, so that's going to give you 13, 16 contagion points.
Hero phase, morbid vigor.
He still doesn't want to die. And movement phase, do you want to move?
Yes, I do. These Nurglings are happy and want to go play with lizards. So they're going to go an extra inch. At the petting zoo, here we come. So those converted plague bearers are down. They are going to hang out in the top left corner of the board, hopefully consuming that victory point for me. All right, we're ready to do some combat. The exercise of futility here is going strong for these guys. So we're going to go with these two Blight Kings first. They are going to put all their damage into these rasps, or the
Spirit Host.
Spirit Host, thank you. Just because, I don't want them to come back. Let's kill this guy.
He's only got 3 wounds left. You can do it.
I can do it.
But I don't want you to.
6?
No, 1-6, and it is going to be...
3.
3 attacks. So these both missed, and so those 2 dice come back, basically. So wounding on 3s.
4.
Alright, I need to make some 4-up saves here.
You do.
Oh, and a 6. I'm going to take a wound.
Who are you going with next?
Dread Scythe Herodins. They've been real embarrassing all game. I know people don't think they're great, but I want to prove you.
You see that? I did that to him.
Well, I'm going to go after the Harbinger of Decay. So I'm hitting on 4s with my scythe limbs and rerolling 1s, which
you didn't get any.
I'm wounding on 3s. 6s do 2 damage. I talked him up. I was like, yeah. What are you doing?
Well, you would never roll on those 6s anyways, thanks to the contagion wheel.
Oh, true, true.
Mm. Oh, and okay. Also, we've totally forgot about Witherstaff the whole time, haven't we?
Yeah, pretty much.
Well, that's okay.
That's okay.
We're going to remember it right now.
And just like that guy said about you guys' last battle report.
which comment was that exactly?
That you guys are so lovable.
Oh, right. We're both lovable.
You want to kill these guys?
Yeah, I'm going to try.
Okay.
Here we go. 6 dice. Here we go. Yeah, that's 6.
Let's get some 6s, buddy.
No. No, just because you said I don't want to do what you tell me.
All right. Do what you tell me!
New song added to the channel.
Oh, dude.
You know, it's just enough. 5s.
Oh,
and 6s.
Oh! You can't sit down!
You can't kill me. You can't see. The one wound, sad executioner. It's closer to this unit of Blight Kings with his decapitating great axe. He gets 2 hits. Oh, but he rerolls 1s from bidding of Nagash's bidding. He wounds on 3s. So there's 2 wounds at -2 rend on these guys. So they're in cover.
6s.
They're actually getting 5s.
5s.
No. Either way, and they're just 1 damage each.
So 5s. No.
Okay. 2's going 3 through.
Damage.
Oh. Oh. Mm-hmm. These scythes are gonna go into the scythes.
These scythes?
So hitting on 3s. Come on, buddy, hit something.
Scythe measuring contest now?
Winning on 3s. Oop, that's 2 wounds. Run 1.
4 up saves. 1's going through for d3 damage.
2.
2. 2 deathless spirits. Make 1 fail 1. So the.
Old Rega's left.
Old Rega. She's
old
back.
Old Rega.
And she's still. Alive, but is she going to get killed? Yeah, by bees.
2 bee dice. Fours.
To be continued.
No.
To be continued. This spirit host can still attack these Blight Kings. He gets a mortal wound, a hit, and that's it. Just a mortal wound. Five up.
No.
That was two. Follow that down.
Battle shock for this guy on a six. He's out of there. He's fine.
Hey, okay.
Now it's roll off between Brent and Josh, I believe, right?
Mm-hmm. So, Josh has got a four. I've got a three. What do you want?
I'm going to go ahead and take that.
Take that.
All right, so for the hero phase, I'm going to pick Shu as my enemy. Let's see if I get a six.
You do. Ooh, yeah. That's come up so many times.
And we're going to choose this unit right here.
All right, roll a dice for each below their armor save of five. You take a mortal wound. So the 10 guys there.
Yeesh.
Ooh. So there's 8 mortal wounds.
And that's going to be a victory point for Josh.
Yes. No, he has to save because he has a...
disgustingly resilient. That's right.
So 5 up. He boxes.
Just 1.
2.
2.
So yep. 6 dead. 4. So you do get a victory point.
Oh, sweet. About time. All right, now I'm going to conjure 3 times, which gives me a grand total of 10 summoning points. And I'm going to attempt Lords of Space and Time twice.
Okay, who's going first?
So the slain is going first.
And he can move after.
And he can move after.
Where's he going? Do you already know? Do you already know where he's going?
Yeah.
He's confident. Drotoka ended up here in the middle of this board edge.
Yeah, he was here.
Over there?
Now he's over there.
Mm. Yeah.
Okay. So now we're going to attempt to move my warden.
Cardor.
No. And he can move.
He does, but he can't move afterwards.
That's what we do.
Okay, so... He ended up right here, right in the center. And so...
Nothing more for your face.
Nothing more for the hero phase. Now for the movement phase.
Who's your enemy?
My enemy will be Shu.
All right, I get to roll to see if I get a point. Nope. Hey, what'd you forget?
I forgot to squirt with those Black Kings. So you know what? You could just go delete your comment now, buddy.
Yeah. Well, this is what happens when we each play 5 or 6 or 11 armies in case of Brent.
You forget thing. Stuff.
But when you see when you play one army, you're measuring and like, okay, I know my guy's teleport.
Yeah. Did you guys know that his guy is a rocket launcher? I have no idea. Like, that happens.
You guys did a little shuffle back so he could be closest to the middle.
And they're going
to
run.
As well. It's just one more inch. Wow, that was generous-ish. An inch.
You don't want to fight. You don't want none of this.
You notice he meticulously measures stuff all day. Oh, I rolled an inch. And that is it for movement. Any charges?
No charges.
Shooting. Who's your enemy?
Shooting. So my enemy is going to be... Who is closest?
Well, you have to shoot the person you're in combat with. Yeah, so. True.
I'm in combat with 2 people if I pick.
Oh, mm-hmm. Pick your favorite.
Yep.
So, they're both you.
So. You're also in combat with the Dread Scythe Harriers.
Yeah. Oh, I didn't know that.
Okay. It's a mess. We
okay, so
we're rolling with it.
I'm going to go ahead and pick Shu as my enemy in the shooting phase. We're going to shoot, see if we can...
Finish his general?
Finish his general, yeah.
Yep, that's a hit.
That is a hit.
You see if you wound him.
Wound.
That is a wound. What a shoe. What you got?
Onto this guy?
Yes, sir. Mm-hmm.
So minus two rent. So I need 6.
We need 5.
5
cover.
No.
D6 damage.
So 3.
And 5 ups against the 3 damage.
Takes 2.
Take 2.
He's dead.
He's dead.
Did you have a kill general as your secret objective?
No, I did not.
No.
Dies alone.
Dies alone.
Oh my gosh, I forgot you were still here.
Alright, so we're going to try to kill Shu right here, so he's going to be my enemy, so I'm going to go ahead and pile in.
Up there. Okay.
He's going to do his bite.
Nope.
Missed. Now his pole arm. 3's it.
Oh, wow. Now it's your turn, Shu. Let him have it.
Gotta get it back. Wait.
Get your own back.
I get to fight again?
Yeah.
That's fun. Okay, well, I picked you as my enemy. This guy's gonna hit you. Here he goes. He's gonna go into this guy here.
Okay.
Right, here we go. Sixes are special, hitting on threes. That's one hit, one wound.
Ooh, got that. No, two up save.
It's not two up anymore, it's a four.
Okay, he's still alive.
Three. Makes it. Because he's in cover.
Yep. All right. Lizards.
All right.
Salamander.
Salamander.
Does he have to reroll sixes to hit?
No, that guy's dead.
Yeah. Okay. Sixes, three is the wound.
Six is the wound.
Minus.
Oh, wait. Roll six. Yeah. Reroll sixes.
Yeah, reroll sixes to wound.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
No. Nope. Two wounds. Two.
So two wounds.
Three
up
save.
One.
Oh, four.
Going up against the Blight King here?
Yep, yep.
All right, here we go. Four, right? Three.
Three. Just two, two.
Yeah. Two.
But
do I hear three?
Three, two, one.
Yep,
save both.
Yeah.
And I think that's it.
Yeah. That's it. Is that
game? You guys always do this. Mom said it's my turn to play the Xbox.
All right.
Okay, so Battle Shock 2.
Oh, yeah. Oh, I'm shocked you guys are bravery 10.
Yep, roll that one. Get D6 back.
I do.
Ooh.
D6.
Oh, four. Just two. If you could have rolled a six, you could have trained all the way over here.
My turn. Choosing Josh in the hero phase. Don't get the six. I am going to use Ruler of the Spirit Host. I'm going to bring back D3 Dreadscythe Herodons. For two, and I'm going to use a command point, and I'm going to try and re-roll my secret objective.
Okay.
Yes.
Yeah. Toward anything?
Or here's the question.
Just right next to the Dreadscythe Herodons. Come on.
You're in combat? So, do they come to my thing?
Maybe. Yeah.
Movement phase, I'm doing a lot of retreating, but since I am wholly within 12 of the Spirit Torment with the Pendant of the Fell Wind, I'm adding plus 3 to my movement. So these Dreadscythe Herodons are running, so they're going to go 12, 15 inches. And the place I want to be is right here at the center of the board, so I can try and score this, presumably, if the game ends this turn.
Center of this quarter is what he's trying to do.
Yeah. Center of this quarter of the board. And should have ran over there, but whatever. Let's retreat with these guys as well. So they're going 9, 11. Yeah. Slaan's still going to have that, but worth a shot. Run away. I've got no shooting. I've got no charges. Combat. I am going to select the Lord Executioner. Lord Executioner first, and he has to pile into the closest model. He's going to go after this putrid Blight King. Here he goes with his decapitating great axe. He's hitting on threes, rerolling ones from Bidding of Nagash.
Bidding of Nagush.
That's good. He's wounding on threes. Sixes do
double damage.
Plus two.
Roll. Yeah.
Oh, well, that guy's dead. Oh, yeah, you're right. Right. Yep. Nurgle, yeah. I have to.
Thank you, Josh.
Thank you.
You're my guy.
There's another guy.
Oh, damn it. I missed it. Yeah, I didn't see it. Yeah, so I'm going to have to do it again. Here we go.
Okay. And it's negative two rent. But you're in cover.
So six. No, fives five. First.
Yep.
And then five again.
You don't have Morbid Vigor, and it's three.
Oh, damage. Right. No Morbid Vigor, right.
So Jesus taking three damage on that guy.
He's got a wound left.
He's got a wound left.
Got a new wound marker there.
So re-rolling my secret objective got me pick on the weak, inflict one or more wounds on a unit from an army of a player that has fewer victory points than you. I had seven, Mark has six, so I'm getting one extra victory point, and then rolling. Not getting that one.
Okay, both of these guys. Well, this guy's going to go here, this guy's going to go there. Let's do it that way. Split up the attacks. Never advised. Always little advice. Here we go. Sixers is special, hitting on threes. No sixes.
Could be enough to kill him.
Threes now. That's all. Ooh, three. No rend.
Four up saves.
Oh!
I got one and a six death of spirit. Nope, he's got a wound left.
Oh, all right, and the other guy here is going to go here into the spirit hosts.
Mm-hmm.
Sixers special, no sixes. Threes. No threes.
All right.
Finishing up here.
Spirit Torment is going to attack Blight Kings with these Shacklegeist chains hitting on fours, rerolling ones, wounding on threes. There's two wounds at negative two rend.
Oh, let's use those. Here we go. Negative two, so looking for sixes.
Ooh, and those are, come on, let's get the six again for 2d3 damage. Nope, that's just three. That's going through.
That's
going
to be enough to kill a guy.
Yeah, it's on that unit. So yep. I actually don't think, oh yeah, he is wounded. Okay. And I'm up to six right now, so there's, with no pylon, so there's, just add me for one more victory point for causing that many damage, because this other spirit host, when they attack, isn't going to be enough to get me another point, but they're just going to fail.
Woo! And that's the turn. You know what I forgot to do, Brent?
Kill my general?
I forgot to attack with that guy. Is he going to try to kill your general?
Yeah, no, that's my fault.
Let's see if I can get three sixes on this attack, everybody.
Yeah, I hope everybody's you don't have for me. Kill my general. Because if you have... Oh,
was a six?
If you have again? Kill my general...
Yeah, five!
It's going to be five.
Oh. So it's six hits. Yeah.
Out of there. All right, here we go. Threes.
Oh.
But still, I've only got a single wound left. Four up saves.
And
a deathless spirit. Six up.
Oh, no! I killed the general.
Do you have kill the general? Do you have kill the...
Nah. Okay. Nah. But I do have to do a wound to a player who has more victory points than me.
That's me. Yeah, so that gives you... Uh-oh. Is that topple? You would topple?
I believe so.
That's
no.
Three?
No, it's two.
Yeah.
Topple's worth three victory points.
Oh, okay, but you had number four. Number four.
Counterattack.
Inflict one more wound on a unit. That's more victory points than you. Oh, okay, never mind.
Yeah, you got two. But you're getting 2 points for that then.
Nice. Fair enough.
Did you have him too?
We've been playing a long time. Does this game keep going?
So, we start with five players. If we roll equal to or higher than the number of players we had, then the game will continue. Let's go ahead and
see what dice.
Oh, absolutely. Crazy. Here we go. The game
is over,
but we're going to have to total up some victory points because now we get to see who controls each section of the board.
Okay, going over it. So, Doug and I have, Doug has five, I have six, so I beat Doug.
It's really important. Thank you for pointing that out. Yeah.
I control the skies, so it's D6 for every.
Yeah.
You know what they say? The underbelly of the sky is the ground.
Nobody's ever.
What's going on?
So anyway, so we have no chance of winning. We're out of the game. But we have
to be clear, though, so we wanted to say I control this section of the board, Mark controls that section of the board. Josh controls every other section of the board.
These four.
Very nice plays with Lords of Space and Time.
Yeah, so Lord of Space and Time is super nice when you are playing Triumph and Treachery, because you can just kind of like do whatever you want and then just go take points.
But don't let a Lizardman or Seraphon player hear you say good things about Seraphon.
Oh, yeah, because they're terrible. Also, if you're wondering about what this is right here, it's like bocce ball. So the person closest to the middle is actually one who gets a point. So it doesn't matter that I got more dudes.
Man, how old are you, Shu? Who plays bocce ball?
We play it every year at the club. Aren't you invited?
Okay, so right now I have 8 points.
Yes.
I'm in the lead. I think I should roll first to see what do we need to beat.
Okay.
So with my 8, I'm getting plus D3 victory points. So I've got a 10. So 10 is what needs to be beat. Let's have Shu roll next.
All right.
Yeah.
Shu has 8, so you can tie.
No, that tie's not going to happen.
Shu.
Or, sorry, no, I had 9?
Oh, yeah, 9. So you have 12.
Right,
11.
11. Okay, so I'm being shoot. So I've got 11. You've got
Josh 3.
Three. Plus 4d3 victory points.
If you roll hot, you got this.
Here we go.
Oh! That's cooked. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 13! 13. You won!
Yeah!
There you go.
Give it.
That's it. So really, none of this matters, just Lords of Space and Time at the end. If you would like to win Triumph of Treachery...
Yeah, just summon stuff, run away, summon...
To be fair, if Shu was playing Seraphon, that would have been 4 more victories.
Yeah, yeah. So.
That's true.
This is a big 2-hour Seraphon commercial.
Yeah. New Battle 2019?
Realm
talk while you put all this away.
Yeah, if you'd like to order the Seraphon, start collecting, find our Amazon affiliate store.
Realm talk, my dudes.
Hey.
What happened? What happened?
Awesome clutch ending from Seraphon.
Totally.
Yeah.
Josh, you did it.
How
do you feel? I think this is the perfect end of this game. Anybody that watched the whole game, I think this is probably the most exciting ending that could have happened, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, because it looked really grim.
3 points to 13.
It looked grim.
For Triumph and Treachery, it's like... games often don't shake out to be like a clutch victory at the end. They often kind of like a slowly moving sword that's going to kill a bunch of people.
Avalanche.
And there's this one person who doesn't die at the end. And this is totally different than what I expected.
Yeah, mobility is key. I think the first time we actually played each other was Triumph and Treachery, and Doug used mobility to win at the very end. And just being able to move, like, because me and Doug were kind of screwed because we're 4-inch guys that can't get around.
Yeah.
He doesn't have his gloves. And so it was rough for us. So we actually,
that's a problem for your girls. But, see, we don't care.
But yeah, it's like it really shows that mobility is key. And I saw that Josh switched last minute. He gamed the system. We were here for fun. He was like, I want this. No, I want that.
So yeah,
there was a lot of my negative hit stuff.
There's a lot of off camera arguing. Actually,
I was the only one who had to fight the I-5 traffic to get here.
Use Lords of Space and Time and skip the freeway.
He's should have just skipped that.
A whack player. A win it outcomes. That guy.
All of the off camera bickering is actually like, wait, I have to do what now? And like, just figuring out what to do. I have to mention, somebody's going to be talking about those Blight Kings that went away because I took the guy out in the middle. Like, I talked about it. I was like, wait, if I put wounds on the leader, then I'm going to, like, break coherency. And they're like, oh, no, you get to pile in combat and be fine. But he didn't die that next round, so he died after that. And then I was like, oh, yeah, that was going to happen, right? Yeah, then it happened. So sometimes you walk into your own fist. That's what happened there. I almost did it again to one of Brent's guys when the rain fell, but it turned out he was actually in coherency. So if you saw that on camera, then the guy teleports up. That's what happened. It's a wobbly model thing.
Secret objectives. I kind of want to say, for me, it was hard to remember that immediately when you score it, then you score those points and draw a new one. So if people are watching the video and being like, oh, Mark actually, you know, scored 16 points and like we didn't know, I mean, we'll have to remember it to actually make it matter. Like, if we did forget anything, then I don't think that changes the outcome at all.
Not really.
And I actually kind of wish that this rule was that you would score them at the end of the battle round, because I feel like that is a lot easier to remember. And I think in similar types of scenarios where there's sort of new objectives coming up, those are always scored at the end of the battle round.
Yeah.
So I'm not sure why in here it's like, I mean, when it's saying, like, immediately, like, where is that? I don't know.
Yeah.
So it's narrative play, doesn't matter.
Yeah. It's fun. I know, a good time.
I know Jack mentioned it, but this game is an anniversary of this group of five players.
Yeah.
This is how we met. We actually met at a home game of Triumph and Treachery, and we decided to launch Ruling Ones right after that game. So you're seeing history in action here. So good times. Thank you very much for watching, and see you on Discord.